Froggy 99.3 is proud to be your home for Union City basketball. Our coverage is sponsored by Tyson Foods in Obion County, Herman Jenkins Motors, Jerry Ward Autoplex, Nutrient Ag Solutions, Commercial Bank and Trust, Titan Tire, Reynolds Brothers Tire Company and Union City, Reynolds Brothers Tire Company and Union City and Martin, American Roofing Soft Wash, Five Seasons Men's Shop in Union City and Martin, Meat Shop, Allen Searcy Builders, The Citizens Bank, Kaiser Pharmacy, Shoe Shack in Union City and Martin, Northwest Tennessee Head Start, McLean Power Systems, Obion County Nursing and Rehab, Trailer Empire, Union City Forklift, Johnson Heating and Air, Kirk Nissan. This is the Tornado Pregame Show with the voice of the Tornadoes, John Coach Eddie Suter.
And welcome to Haywood High School for tonight's doubleheader between the Union City Golden Tornadoes and the Haywood Tomcats. I'm John Thornton. I'll be alongside you tonight as Union City in their penultimate doubleheader before the Christmas holiday, making the long road trip to Brownsville after a home doubleheader last night against South Gibson. And a quick turnaround for these two teams trying to get back into the win column. Both teams coming off losses last night, and both teams now trying to avenge those losses tonight as it is Union City and Haywood here on the road in Brownsville tonight. It is the Tornado Pregame Show on Froggy 99.3 presented by Tyson Foods in Obion County and Herman Jenkins Motors. Well, Union City's girls will lead off the doubleheader as they tend to do, and they will try and pick up another win over Haywood, a team they have seen once already this season and picked up a win over them earlier in the year. 59-25, Union City was in a back-and-forth game early on before they pulled away with three girls in double figures in that game. And so tonight we'll try and duplicate that feat. But the first thing on their mind will be turning the page, as Coach Kobe talked about it earlier on last night, is trying to turn the page quickly after a 59-42 loss at home last night to South Gibson. They battled offensively, but then in the third quarter, a big run by South Gibson pulled the Lady Hornets away, and Union City was unable to match the scoring run from South Gibson and fell by a 17-point margin. It was the defense of the Lady Hornets that proved to be a critical point of difference in that game, as the Hornets took away two of Union City's top four options offensively, as Adesia Snow and Debriana Jones really never got any clean looks for Union City. And it is so important for this basketball team to have other girls involved in the scoring column. Neither of those girls really ever able to get any clean looks. That was a big part in the loss. Ajani Moss chipped in a couple of threes on the other end for Union City coming off the bench, but one of the things that continues to plague Union City bit them in the butt last night, and that is second chance points, as South Gibson, especially on me, it was never more evident than on the first possession of the game, as Union City second and third chance opportunities surrendered to South Gibson, and the Lady Hornets were able to capitalize on that. South Gibson, not the best shooting team, but they did get inside on Union City and really caused Union City problems, not just on offense, but on the glass as well. Another big factor, Union City, a team that is so heavily involved and invested in forcing turnovers and trying to get teams to give them easy opportunities on the other end by turning defense into offense. That was something they could not do last night. You could not force turnovers. A very experienced South Gibson team really controlled the basketball and did not turn the ball over. Did a very nice job of hurting Union City in transition and on the back end of the press. Took care of the basketball, and Union City really could never get them uncomfortable. As South Gibson Coach Suter talked about, it gave them several different looks defensively as well. We saw several different times they give Union City a zone, a man-to-man, several different press looks. It was a team that really Union City just struggled with from the jump. And so now trying to get back into the win column after now dropping their last two of the week and trying to avoid a winless week, as this will be game number three on the week. And how much energy does Coach Kobe and this team have left in the tank, especially after a long road trip? We'll find out here tonight against the team they've seen once already this season in Haywood. Again, a game which Union City won going away, went on a run of 27 unanswered points from late in the first quarter until midway through the third. The last time these two teams met, and that propelled Union City to the victory. Amari Bonds with 21 points. Marley Theobald dropped in 15. Debriana Jones chipped in 10. And so 46 of the 59 coming between those three, and that helped Union City get on to a two-game winning streak back at the time. Marley Theobald had a three-pointer in the middle of the opening frame that really helped Union City, gave them the late lead in the first quarter. And then Amari Bonds, 10 points in the second quarter. And the defensively, which Union City has made their calling card this season, they held Haywood nearly scoreless in the or entirely scoreless in the second period in half of the third, and jumped out to a 30-12 lead at the halftime break. And then Adesia Snow got going, a couple of three-pointers, stretched the lead even further. Eight total threes in the win the last time these two teams met, and so Union City going to try and duplicate that feat. But one of the things they've got to do better, and Coach Kobe's even talked about it, trying to get the ball inside of Debriana Jones and trying to get her more involved offensively. Coach Suter has talked about it quite a bit, that she's good at creating her own offense on stick backs, but obviously when teams have zoned Union City, they've struggled with it to get them into the sensitive spots at the high post and in the short corner. They tried to against Henry County, got several looks for Debriana Jones, and obviously she is still a raw product, as he talked about trying to get her more involved offensively and giving her some cleaner looks on that end as well. So we'll see what Union City does tonight. They'll need all their role players clicking on all cylinders as they take on Haywood for the second time this season here on the Tornado Pregame Show on Froggy 99.3 and Radio NWTN.com, presented by Tyson Foods in Obion County and Herman Jenkins Motors. We'll take a quick break. We'll come back. More pregame coverage coming up after the break, right after this on the home of Union City Sports, Froggy 99.3.
Looking for a career change? You should join the friendly team at Tyson Foods in Union City. Apply now for general production positions up to $21.90 plus a shift premium. Tyson offers excellent benefits, including paid vacation, company matching 401k plans, and more. Apply online anytime at Tyson.com/careers, in person at 2800 Tyson Drive, or Monday through Friday, 8 to 5 at the Tyson Hiring Center off Real Foot in Union City. Tyson Foods in Obion County is hiring now. Tyson Foods is an equal opportunity employer, including disability and veterans.
At Reynolds Brothers Tire Company in Union City and Martin, they carry Cooper, Michelin, and Goodyear tires. In fact, they carry all major brands and many private brands, too. They even go the extra mile for their customers with a service package that includes road hazard, fix-free flats, and lifetime balancing. Reynolds Brothers, nobody beats their customer service. Reynolds Brothers Tire Company, 400 East Church Street in Union City and 505 North Lindell Street in Martin.
In today's economy, small businesses and consumers need every advantage to survive and get ahead. That's where community banks come in. Hi, I'm Tim Shanks at Commercial Bank and Trust Company. We give you the chance to succeed by providing the tools to start a small business, buy a home, fund a retirement, and fuel your dreams. Stop by and see us and let us show you why community banks build better communities. When banking matters, it matters who you bank with. Commercial Bank and Trust Company, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
For your next car or truck, come see Jerry Ward Autoplex in Union City. Jerry Ward and his all-star team have a lot filled with pre-owned small, mid-sized, and full-size cars, SUVs, and nice trucks, too. And if they don't have the right size, they'll find it for you. No matter what you're looking for, score your next ride at Jerry Ward Autoplex, Real Foot Avenue in Union City, or online at jerrywardautoplex.com. Like Jerry always says, don't dream it, drive it. Be a winner with Jerry Ward Autoplex in Union City.
High school live on the Tornado Pregame Show on Froggy 99.3 and Radio NWTN.com, presented by Tyson Foods in Obion County and Herman Jenkins Motors, as Union City takes on Haywood in a road doubleheader, a return trip after the Tomcats made the trip up to Union City back in late November. Well, Haywood girls, they've really struggled this season, entering year two under head coach Kayla Sheets, 5-19 last season, and fell in the region 8 AAA quarterfinals in a program that's trying to kind of get some mojo back. It's a program that has had some good runs. As recently as 2018, made a run to the state semifinals before tragedy struck and Coach Patrice Boyd suddenly passed away in 2020-21, and Coach Sheets took over the reins of the program. And this season off to a tough start. They've lost their last six, each of those by double digits, and none of them have been particularly close. It has been a really tough go of it for Coach Sheets and his team. We'll take a look at some of those score lines here in just a second, because it is a team that is really kind of struggling here as we hurtle toward the Thanksgiving holiday. You look at some of these most recent score lines: 67-45 to White Station, 61-32 to Westview, 54-16 to Crockett County, 68-29 to Fayette Ware, and then last night 79-26 to an always good Jackson Southside program. So again, this Haywood team trying to kind of bounce back, trying to get back on its feet. And Union City going to have to not overlook this team coming off a loss of their own last night as well. And a team that is really struggling, similar to Union City at times, to score the basketball, just averaging 37.3 points per game and allowing 64.1. Last time we saw this team, they started about four freshmen, and so a very young team as well for Coach Sheet. But Union City will have their work cut out for them tonight. They cannot overlook this team because if they do, they could come out on the losing end. Let's take a look at the keys to the game tonight, brought to you by Jerry Ward Autoplex for Union City. First and foremost, they've got to control the glass. They cannot give Haywood second, third, and fourth chance opportunities. You have to rebound the basketball if you're going to beat a decent team in Haywood or really any team in general. A great opportunity tonight to give themselves a chance to kind of get back into that mojo of controlling the glass. Defensively as well, you've got to find a way to force turnovers. They struggled to do that last night against South Gibson. They have to take care of the basketball, but they also have got to force teams into turnovers to give themselves easy offense on the other end of the floor. And finally, get inside in the lane offensively. Get some easy looks at the rim. Give it to Debriana Jones or Ajani Moss on the block and give yourselves a chance at some clean looks down below. Those keys to the games brought to you by Jerry Ward Autoplex. Score your next set of keys from Jerry and the guys today. This Tornado pregame show again brought to you by Tyson Foods in Obion County and Herman Jenkins Motors as Union City taking on Haywood tonight, entering at 3-7 on the season. Haywood coming in at 1-9. But again, both teams have really struggled here of late in Union City, losers of their last two against very high-quality competition and trying to get, at least build some confidence back, because that's one thing this team has kind of struggled with up and down this season. They've had some confidence issues with some of the other girls that they're trying to rely on outside of Amari Bonds. Obviously, we've talked about it. You're trying to get a Deja Snow more comfortable shooting the three ball, trying to get Marley Theobald more aggressive at taking it to the hole or even taking some three balls as well. And Ajani Moss, getting her more involved offensively. She's got to be better about not getting into foul trouble. That's been one of her key issues as well. She's a very gritty and aggressive defender, and so Union City going to have to keep her out on the floor. But we've also seen several younger girls get some playing time, and so we'll see if Union City continues to get more involved in the bench. The national anthem coming up as well as Nutrien Ag starting lineups. We will take a break when we come back. Starting lineups and the opening tip-off. Stay tuned. More coming up right after this on the home of Union City Sports, WWGY Fulton, Froggy 99.3 in Union City.
American Roofing Soft Wash is your roof cleaning expert. For all kinds of pressure washing, contact KB at American Roofing Soft Wash. They also do patios, driveways, gutters, sidewalks, vinyl siding, semi-trucks, trailers, and heavy equipment. American Roofing Soft Wash specializes in dirty roofs, and by cleaning your roof, it'll preserve the shingles, adding 2 to 5 years of life. Check them out on Facebook at American Roofing Soft Wash or call KB at 731-636-9700. American Roofing Soft Wash, making roofs look great again.
At Five Seasons Men's Shop, they carry key brand names. Southern Marsh, Vineyard Vines, Fish Hippie, Michael Kors, and lots more. From suits to sportswear, from shoes to tuxedos, Five Seasons is the store where you'll find it all for the man who wants more. Remember, Five Seasons has big and tall sizes up to 4X and youth sizes as well. Be sure and follow Five Seasons Men's Shop on Facebook for daily specials. Five Seasons Men's Shop in Union City and Martin. Walk in a man, walk out the man.
Make every season count. Start with Nutrien Ag Solutions. Every season starts by choosing the right seed for your unique growing conditions. Nutrien Ag Solutions carries a wide selection of top-performing seed brands, including Dyna-Grow seed, to get the most out of your acres. You also have the advantage of working with local seed experts, crop consultants, and agronomists ready to provide a custom recommendation to help you make the right decision every time. In Union City, visit Nutrien Ag Solutions at 530 North 5th Street. That's Nutrien Ag Solutions in Union City.
Hi, this is Lynn Jenkins from Herman Jenkins Motors in Union City, Tennessee. On behalf of our entire staff, we want to say thank you for your continued support of our business. This Christmas season, may you and your family be blessed and enjoy the gift of one another. If you are looking for that special gift on wheels, stop by and see us at Herman Jenkins Motors, and we'll get you in a Chevrolet or GMC that fits your needs. Also, don't forget to check us out online at HermanJenkinsUnionCity.com. Merry Christmas and Happy New Year's from all of us here at Herman Jenkins Motors.
It's the playing of our national anthem here tonight at Haywood High School as we get set for tip-off between Haywood and Union City. Nutrien Ag starting lineups. We'll take a look at those. Union City will start with the typical five that has become their normal five. At forward, a sophomore, number 10, Demriana Jones. At guard, a junior, number 12, Ada Rogers. At guard, another junior, number 21, Marley Theobald. At forward, a senior, number 22, Adasia Snow. And at guard, another senior, number 23, Amari Bonds. I'm trying to see if I can track down the numbers for the Haywood starting five. We're kind of at an awkward angle here tonight from my vantage point. And we'll get those to you here in just a moment. Union City will wear the gray on gray combination, the road uniforms, purple numbering and lettering with gold trim. Union City led by head coach Antoine Kobe, assisted by Nelson Youngblood and Mason Story, coming in with a 3-7 record on the season. So for Haywood, they'll start like this. At guard, a freshman, number 1, Kamaria Woodland. At guard, number 3, a junior, Sharonica Wilkes. A senior, number 13, Megan Garrison. And then another freshman, number 14, Zamaria Murphy. And rounding out the starting five for Haywood, number 51, Alana Perkins. Haywood wearing the home white on white, purple lettering and numbering and white trim for the home Tomcats here tonight. Demriana Jones will jump. Perkins will jump for Haywood. Union City will go left to right on your radio dial. Haywood will go left to right. Actually, Jones is going to jump against Woodland, who had a really good game the last time these two teams met, was the biggest source of offense for Haywood. And is only a freshman and rather raw, but perhaps Haywood can get her going in the future and give themselves a bright future. Opening tap is won by Woodland, and Haywood will bring it into the front court, and we are underway here at Haywood High School. It's Garrison giving it off on the right wing to Wilkes. They'll float it back across left wing to Woodland. Woodland brings it back top of the key, swings for Garrison, right wing. Back out to Woodland. Woodland swings it left wing to Murphy. On the drive, Murphy forces one up. Rebound tapped out of bounds, and it's going to go to Union City. So Bonds will push it into the front court for Union City. Top of the key on the right wing, gives him the corner to Rogers. Back out top of the key, Snow. Back to Bonds, right wing. Bonds around a screen, hands off Theobald. Directing the offense, Theobald around a Rogers screen on the right wing, gives him the corner, Snow, a pump. Snow down inside. Bonds, a turnaround two, will not get it to drop. Rebound corralled by Murphy. Coming the other way is Haywood, kicking it in the corner for Wilkes. Wilkes will fire for three, and it wouldn't go. Halfway down, it tapped back up and in. Garrison is going to get credit for the deuce. 2-0 Haywood, 6:51 to go first quarter. On a stick back there for Haywood. Rogers inside to Bonds at the elbow. Kicks back out. Theobald swinging it to Snow. Back to Theobald, top of the key. Right wing to Bonds, back to Rogers on the right wing. Bonds back with it, top of the key. Tosses to Rogers, who drives. Short and long two there for Jones that will find the bottom of the net. Jones stepping out and showing a bit of range and drilling a two-point jumper. Now Union City with some pressure. Bonds going to be whistled for a foul, trying to apply some pressure on the pass. Two to two, 6:17 to go first quarter. as Woodland will bring it into the front court for Haywood. Swings it across the court for Wilkes. Now into the corner, it's Garrison. Back out, Wilkes, top of the key. Right wing, Woodland. She'll fire for three. Woodland finds the bottom of the net for Haywood. 5-2, the new score. Haywood by three. 5:50 to go, first quarter. Snow, top of the key, gives up for Theobald. Back to Snow, left wing. Snow going to fire for three for the tie. Can't get it to go. Perkins the rebound for Haywood. Murphy trying to go coast to coast. Throws one off the glass, wouldn't go. Some contact, but no call. Theobald trying to push it for Union City. Right wing to Bonds with space. Will fire for three in the tie, and Bonds gets it to get it go through. Timeout on the floor, a Commercial Bank timeout. 5:26 to go, first quarter. And Union City and Haywood tied at five apiece. Back in 30 seconds on the home of Union City Sports, Froggy 99.3.
Your next car or truck, come see Jerry Ward Autoplex in Union City. Jerry Ward and his all-star team have a lot filled with pre-owned small, mid-sized, and full-size cars, SUVs, and nice trucks, too. And if they don't have the right size, they'll find it for you. No matter what you're looking for, score your next ride at Jerry Ward Autoplex, Real Foot Avenue in Union City, or online at jerrywardautoplex.com. Like Jerry always says, don't dream it, drive it. Be a winner with Jerry Ward Autoplex in Union City.
At five as Haywood turns this one over out of the Commercial Bank timeout. 5:16 to go in quarter number one. We're tied at five apiece. Marley Theobald will bring it up the floor for Union City. On the right wing, gives into the corner for Moss, who's just checked in. Moss will fire for three and knock one down. Angenie Moss picking up where she left off last night. Had a couple of threes off the bench. Gives Union City an 8-5 lead. Perkins, top of the key, will dish down low and driving to the basket and scoring. For Haywood is Murphy. Theobald up the floor to Bonds on the left wing. Bonds pulls up long two, wouldn't go, rebounded by Murphy. 8-7, Union City by one. Perkins dish it over to Woodland on the right wing. Woodland hands it off for Wilkes. Swings left wing, and Murphy or Garrison fires for three. It won't go, rolling out of bounds, and it will turn back over to Union City. Snow's going to check back in. Angenie Moss will check out. 8-7, Union City with a one-point lead, 4:20 to go here in the first quarter. Rogers will bring it across the timeline. Kicks over to Bonds, back to Rogers. Dishes for Marley Theobald in the corner to Snow. Snow back out, Theobald. Back to Bonds with space. Bonds will fire another three. This one wouldn't go. Rebound tipped loose and is corralled by Garrison. Off and running on the left wing. Driving and pulling up for a long two. In and out, it wouldn't drop for Wilkes. Theobald in the corner to Rogers. Down low to a streaking Theobald. Into the lane. Theobald, little floater, will rattle home for Union City. Lead is 10-7, 3:35 to go, first quarter for Union City. Woodland on the drive, tossing one up, but it wouldn't go, but a foul is called, and we'll send Woodland to the free throw line. It's on Debriana Jones. It'll be her first. And Woodland, well, get the first to drop. As Perkins will check out. And Woodland goes 2-for-2. 10-9, the new score. Union City with a one-point lead. Rogers on the right wing, gives it back out to Theobald. Bonds, left wing. Pass deflected and knocked out of bounds off of Murphy. And it will stay with Union City. 3:09 to go, first quarter. The team's going back and forth a little bit here in the early going. Bonds bringing it up herself. Around a double screen. Kicks out to Theobald. Top of the key, Snow. Get a fire for three. Snow will knock one down from distance. Four different Union City players, or five Union City players have scored here in the first quarter. 13-9 as Woodland pumps. Kicks it back out to Wilkes. On the right wing, it's Garrison now. Passes loose, stolen away by Theobald. And a jump ball, and the arrow is with Union City. And so far, Jones on the score sheet with two, Marley Theobald with two, Snow, Bonds, and Moss have all connected on triples. 13-9, Union City by four. 2:25 to go, first quarter. Bonds on the right wing, gets around a screen, pulls up, now going to swing in the corner. Snow going to try again. Why not? And knocks another through. Timeout on the floor, 16-9, Union City by seven after another Snow trifecta, 2:16 to go. We'll keep it right here as Union City off to a red-hot start from distance. Struggled to get it going last night, but have jumped out to a seven-point lead here late in the first quarter as Haywood wanting to talk some things over. Let's go to the Reynolds Brothers Tire Company in Union City and in Martin scoreboard as Bradford girls picking up a win 46-24 today over Halls. Fayette Ware picks up a win over Bolivar 60-48. That's also another final from earlier today in girls action. Back to action we are here. Woodland, right wing, flinging it back for Wilkes. Inside, Murphy. Back out to Wilkes. And driving into the lane, it couldn't go for Wilkes there. Rebounded by Bonds. Under 2 minutes to go, first quarter. Bonds into the front court. Gives off for Theobald around the screen. Theobald going to drive and is whistled for a traveling violation that will turn it back over to Haywood. And now Moss, Turner, and Jeremiah Fair all checking into the game for Union City. Some length for the Golden Tornadoes on the floor. Woodland swings it over to Wilkes. Back to Woodland, top of the key. Woodland left wing to Wilkes again. Dishing it to Murphy, into the lane, forcing one up. It wouldn't go for Murphy and out of bounds. And another Haywood turnover back to Union City. A minute to go, minute and a half to go here in the first. Theobald into the front court. Gives off right wing to Bonds. Bonds spins at the free throw line, kicks in the corner to Theobald. Theobald back to Fair. She's going to fire for three. That one wouldn't go. Rebound Woodland. Woodland trying to bring it ahead herself. Trying to go coast to coast. Kicks it back out. Wilkes with it on the left wing. And now barreling into the lane is Murphy. And a whistle and a foul. And the shot would not go. But Murphy will head to the free throw line for Haywood. That was Turner who picked up the foul. And that one will drop for Murphy. Haywood 3-for-3 on their first couple of free throws. Shakira Taylor checking into the game for the Tomcats. 2-for-2 on that trip. And so Haywood 4-for-4 from the line to open the night. They've cut the Union City lead to 5, 16-11, a minute to go, first quarter. Theobald getting past some pressure from Haywood into the front court. Crossing over and a whistle and an offensive foul on Marley Theobald and a turnover back to Haywood. Woodland into the front court, giving it off on the right wing to Garrison. Garrison driving into the lane, had it ripped away. Still loose on the floor. Haywood recovers. Blocked out away by Bonds, and a three from the corner would not go for Taylor. Snow comes out with the rebound and a foul. Going to go on Haywood. Could not see. Foul going to go on Trevica Pugh. Be the first team foul against Haywood here in the first quarter. Theobald gets it in inbounds for Bonds. Back to Theobald. 26 seconds to go in the first quarter, 16-11. Theobald driving it inside, and a whistle and a foul, and Marley Theobald will head to the stripe. On Shakira Taylor will be her first and first free throw attempts of the night for Union City. Marley Theobald will shoot them and drops in the first. Theobald, 2 for 2. Now 4 points for her on the evening. And the lead is 18-11, 22.9 left in the first quarter as Bonds and Theobald will check out. Jones and Turner back into the game for Union City. As Garrison with it on the right wing, getting it down low. That shot wouldn't go for Pugh. Rebound, fought for, three bodies on the floor. And a jump ball with the arrow going to Union City. They're going to say it's Haywood basketball. The arrow on the scoreboard must be off. Inbound and knocked away by Rogers. And now Theobald is going to check back in for Union City. Inbounded to Woodland. 9 seconds for Haywood. Woodland going to go. Driving into the lane. Pushes one off the glass. Wouldn't go. Rebound tipped around to Jones. 2 seconds. Jones to Theobald. And Union City going to head into the second quarter with an 18-11 lead over Haywood. We will take a break. We'll come back with the second stanza. Coming up after this on the other side on the home of Union City Sports, Froggy 99.3.
Well, howdy. Pull up a saddle and sit a spell.
Hey, what's that?
Oh, that there on the campfire? Well, that there's the best tasting slab of beef this side of the Rockies. A ribeye from the meat shop. A bone-in ribeye from the meat shop means extra flavor, custom cut every time, and if it were any fresher, it'd still be mooing. Hitch up the horses, head on over to the meat shop, 1106 South 1st Street in Union City.
A good foundation. At Allen Searcy Builder Contractors, they know that it's the essential part of having a successful project, but it's also an important element in each relationship with their clients. Understanding and protecting the interests of each business they serve is why Allen Searcy continues to be the source for major commercial projects in our area for over 40 years. Allen Searcy Builder Contractors can help you with your project from concept and design all the way to construction. Call 885-7633 or go to allencearcy.com.
to 11, Union City by 7 here in the girls' portion of our doubleheader tonight. Union City leading Haywood by 7 as we start quarter number 2. Bonds will bring it across the timeline for Union City on the right wing. Gives up to Theobald. Working it on the left wing and now going to bring it back top of the key. Swings to Snow. Now in the corner, Rogers. Back out to Snow. Snow back to Bonds. Bonds with space. Union City firing for three. Bonds couldn't take advantage of the breakdown. Perkins the rebound, and off and running comes Haywood. Woodland slows down. Floats inside. Perkins spinning, runs into contact, gives it down low, up and in on the high low to Garrison. Cuts the lead to 5, 18-13, 7:14 to go in the second quarter. Rogers. Right wing gives off top of the key to Theobald. Weaving her way into the lane. Blocked and a foul on Perkins. Theobald being very aggressive and attacking inside. And not a shooting foul, they say. Or will they give the free throws? They will give the free throws as Theobald gingerly walk into the free throw line. 4 points on the night, was 2 for 2 in her first trip. And knocks down that one. Defense! And Theobald goes 2 for 2 on that trip. And now 4 for 4 from the line. She's got 6 points here in the first half. The lead back to 7, 20-13, 7:03 to go. And a near steal here by Snow, recovered by Taylor, and a traveling violation on Haywood. And that will turn it back over to Union City. Theobald inbounds to Bonds. Bonds crosses over on the left wing, and a whistle and a quick foul. That one going to go on Garrison. Theobald to inbound, gives it to Bonds. Bonds on the drive, into the lane, through contact, and can't get the finish. Puts it back up and in, and a foul on the putback, and Bonds going to head to the free throw line. That is on Woodland, and her first personal. As Bonds will rattle home the first foul shot. Two for two for Bonds on that trip. She's now got 5. Quickly comes Woodland on the other end. Down low to Perkins and a steal by Theobald. And a whistle and another foul on Haywood. Bonds will bring it up. Looks like it was an offensive foul traveling on Haywood. Bonds will pull up, goes coast to coast, couldn't get the shot to go. Perkins the rebound. And now a late foul and a call on Amari Bonds. Will be her second. Woodland gives off. Taylor will fire for 3. They'll roll out of bounds and another turnover back to Union City. 22-13, 6:03 to go in the second quarter. And Union City in front by 9. Theobald up the floor, around a double screen. Picks up the dribble, looking for help. Gives it off to Snow. Snow on the attack, pulls up at the elbow, turning, looking, finds Moss. A pump fake and a double dribble and a turnover back to Haywood. As Jayla Turner will check back in. Bonds will take a rest with 2 fouls. Down inside to Perkins, a double team. They kick it back out. Murphy in the corner. Looking for help. Murphy across the court pass. Saved by Woodland on the attack, and Woodland somehow gets it up and in. 7 points for her. That's the lead to 7. 22-15. 5:16 to go in the second quarter. Theobald spinning top of the key. Around a Jones screen. Theobald on the attack. Into the lane and a whistle and a foul on the floor on Haywood. Two on Taylor as Turner will check out and Bonds will check back in. Theobald to inbound. Trying to find anybody. And a 5-second violation on Union City is going to turn it back over to Haywood. Woodland going to try and push the tempo quickly for the Lady Tomcats. Looks it on the left wing. And now a 3 will drop for Murphy. And Murphy now with 5 points, a Commercial Bank timeout on the floor as Haywood cuts the lead to 4, 4:52 to go second quarter, back in 30 seconds on the home of Union City Sports, Froggy 99.3.
The Citizen Bank online banking allows their customers secure and convenient access to their accounts using the internet anytime. With some of their online banking functions, you can access and print information on all of your accounts, including loans. Confirm your deposits, withdrawals, and checks cleared. View deposits and checks cleared, and receive email alerts. Now that's taking care of business for you. The Citizens Bank, Hickman, Fulton, and Union City. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Back to action we go. Theobald drives, kicks out to Snow. As Haywood has cut Union City's lead to four, and a turnover into the backcourt. Driving to the cup and cannot get it to go. Put back up and in by Woodland. 9 points in the first half for Woodland. That cuts Haywood's deficit to two. And Rogers going to fire a right wing three. That one won't go, and a rebound by Murphy. And a tie up and a jump ball after the rebound is going to turn it back over to Union City. Theobald pumps, floats it inside. Rogers pass deflected, and a steal by Murphy. Murphy on the breakaway, lays it up and lays it in, and Haywood will tie the game. A 9-0 run for the Tomcats. We'll tie it up at 22 with 4:10 to go here in the first half. Theobald, Rogers now will bring it ahead. Rogers, top of the key. To Murphy, to Theobald, into the lane, back out to Snow. Left wing, crossing over. Snow into the lane, forces one with the right hand. It wouldn't go. Rebound Haywood, pushing in transition. Garrison on the left wing, driving to the basket, and Garrison lays it up and in, and Haywood will take the lead at 24-22. An 11-0 run for the Lady Tomcats to take a two-point lead, and a whistle and a foul, and an offensive foul on Bonds. Will be her third in another Union City turnover. Three and a half to go, second quarter. Haywood has stormed back with a two-point lead here late in the second quarter. Taylor going to fire, trying to add to it. Blocked by Moss. Chance for Union City to tie it up again. Theobald up the floor to Rogers on the left wing. Top of the key to Snow. Back to Rogers on the left wing. Rogers on the left wing. Gives off to Theobald. Theobald drives, gives off to Snow on the right wing. Snow on the attack, back out to Rogers. A Bond sitting right now with three fouls as Rogers gets hammered in the lane by Perkins. Popping back up, but a hard foul. Will be two on Perkins, and Rogers going to head to the free throw line for Union City, her first trip tonight. Has yet to get on the score sheet. But will with that free throw. And a Commercial Bank timeout on the floor for Haywood. 24-23 as Rogers will have one more after the timeout. We'll go back to the Reynolds Brothers Tire Company scoreboard. As Union City now down by one after a huge run by Haywood. Again, some finals from earlier today. Bradford picking up a win 46-24 over Halls. Gibson County played Henry County earlier in the day. Do not have a final on that one. Fayette Ware picked up the win over Bolivar 60-48. Dyersburg boys picked up a win over Gibson County 58-48. That was the Charles Coles Classic. And that was last night. Big win for Liberty last night. They defeated JCM 66-25. Stay tuned when we come to halftime. The Tornado Halftime Report presented by the Union City Board of Education, as well as the halftime stats powered by American Roofing Softwash. 2:52 to go, second quarter. Union City trailing Haywood 24-23. As Ada Rogers at the line, both teams set to shoot at least a 1-1 the rest of this first half. Rogers goes 1 of 2. First free throw miss for Union City of the night, and quickly comes Murphy and a whistle and a turnover on Haywood. Too many steps. Inbounded, but a steal by Woodland. Woodland on the drive, lays it up, couldn't finish. Rebound, Rogers. Rogers now lofting it ahead to Moss. Moss trying to maintain. Pass deflected, saved by Woodland. Back inbound for Murphy. Murphy will bring it the other way for Haywood. Pass tipped and still loose. Murphy saves. It rolls out of bounds and a turnover back to Union City. They lob it into Snow, who just maintains control, swings it over to Jones. Jones now will drive, flings it into the corner. Moss back out to Snow, goes through her legs. She saves it. Snow now will dribble into the lane, down low to Jones, and it's going to roll out of bounds. And another turnover, this one back to Haywood. Woodland will bring it up. Haywood leads 24-23, 2:06 to go second quarter. On the drive is Garrison. That one wouldn't go. Rebounded by Rogers. Up ahead to Marley Theobald. Theobald, right wing, Moss. Free throw line, floater off the window, wouldn't go. Rebound tapped and quickly out and running is Garrison in transition. Garrison to the cup, puts it up off the front iron, wouldn't go. Rebounded by Pugh, and Pugh throws it away. And it will turn back over to, well, it's going to stay with Haywood, deflected by Union City. As Turner will check in, out comes Moss. 1:41 to go in the first half. Union City is led by as many as 9, but a Haywood 11-0 surge took the lead at 24-22. Rogers knocked down a free throw to cut it back to 1. Long 2 on the baseline, wouldn't go, but the rebound is tracked down by Garrison. Taylor, right wing for Woodland. Woodland going to try a deep triple. Woodland can't hit. Rebounded by Rogers, who bobbles it. Rogers saves, back to Theobald. 1:20 to go in the second quarter. Around a Rogers screen with Theobald. Back to Rogers on the left wing. It's just back to Theobald. Theobald on the drive, gives to a cutting Snow. Snow on the attack, lays it up and lays it in, and Union City retakes the lead. And a long 2 from Woodland wouldn't go, and a traveling violation against Union City. Union City by 2. 57 seconds to go in the first half. Union City hanging on to a 1-point lead. Theobald over to Rogers will fire a 3 off the back iron. Wouldn't go. Offensive rebound to Jones. Throwing one back up that goes out of bounds and will turn back over to Haywood. Woodland will bring it ahead for the Lady Tomcats. 40 seconds to go in the first half. On the left wing is Murphy, and a traveling violation on Murphy is going to turn it back over to Union City. Haywood has struggled tonight with too many turnovers. And that has been one way Union City has been able to stay alive and keep this game going. They have struggled at times just... 7 points here in the second quarter. Theobald, right wing, and a whistle and a traveling violation on Union City. And a turnover. Back to Haywood. They can hold for the final shot here. 21 seconds to go, first half. Woodland, top of the key. We're going to work this clock down. With nine, Woodland with seven. Woodland on the attack, around a screen. Swings it over to Taylor with 3 seconds. Taylor on the attack through contact, and the clock will expire, and that is going to bring us to halftime. Union City leads Haywood 25-24 as we head into the halftime break. We'll take a break. We'll come back with the halftime stats presented by American Roofing Softwash. Stay tuned. More coming up right after this on the home of Union City Sports, Froggy 99.3.
Have you heard the news? Kaiser Pharmacy has a new gift shop, Miles and Bishop. You've always known us for our unique baby gifts, but we decided it's time to expand and offer gifts for all occasions. While you're here shopping for others, be sure to pick up a little happy for yourself. You deserve it. Come see Olivia Riley at Miles and Bishop, where the gift wrapping and service is free. Remember, it's now Miles and Bishop inside Kaiser Pharmacy in Union City.
Remember Shoe Shack in Union City for neighbor and shoes and boots, both ladies and men's clothing and the trendiest accessories, hats, purses, bags, and lots more. Come shop Shoe Shack for exciting arrivals for the season. Shoe Shack can clothe your entire family from head to toe. Be sure and follow Shoe Shack in Union City on Facebook for their very latest arrivals. For every season, please shop local and shop Shoe Shack in Union City, 2800 East Ruleford Avenue in Union City.
.25-24, the halftime score. Union City in front by one, but a back and forth second quarter where Haywood able to surge back into the game on an 11-0 run. Let's take a look at the halftime stats presented by American Roofing Softwash. Union City looking like this on the score sheet. Debriana Jones with 2 points. Ada Rogers has one. Three for Ajani Moss, six for Marley Theobald, and Adasia Snow leading Union City with eight in the first half. Kamaria Woodland leading all scores with nine, but 6 points from Megan Garrison, and Zamaria Murphy from seven rounds out the scoring for Haywood as they've got three girls who have really helped them. For Union City, it is far more balanced so far. Union City led it 18-11 after one, but now their lead is down to 25-24 as Haywood outscores them 13-7 here in the second quarter. We'll take a break. We'll come back with the Tornado Halftime Report on the home of Union City Sports, Froggy 99.3, right after this here on Froggy 99.3.
This is Larry Sherwood, administrator of Ural Vine County Nursing and Rehab. So now the unthinkable has happened. You are not prepared to hear these words, and you are hoping that you would never hear them. Your mom or dad needs the services of a nursing home. Now what? Call Vine County Nursing and Rehab. We are here to help. You have questions? We have the answers that will help guide you into making the right decisions. So come meet our family who cares for your family at Obion County Nursing and Rehab, 1084 East County Home Road, Union City, Tennessee.
Are you looking for an early learning program that not only gives your child a head start on their learning journey, but also works with the entire family? If so, Northwest Tennessee Head Start, Early Head Start is excited to share that they are accepting applications for the 2022-23 school year. Don't miss out on this opportunity. Northwest Tennessee Head Start, with locations in McKenzie, Paris, Union City, Troy, Huntingdon, Tiptonville, Dresden, Kenton, Puryear, Milan, Brewston, Humboldt, Trenton, Camden, and Jackson. To enroll your child today, text in Enroll to 68683. That's Enroll to 68683.
McLean Power Systems of Trenton is hiring for manufacturing positions. From welders to assemblers and everything in between, they have the perfect opportunity for you. At McLean Power Systems, they understand how important work-life balance is. Team members can work 5 days a week or volunteer for as much overtime as they'd like. With positions available on first, second, and third shifts, you can work on a schedule that benefits you and your family. To apply, text the word POWER to 30605. McLean Power Systems is an equal opportunity employer.
For all your trailer needs, Trailer Empire in Union City is your go-to source. From small trailers to big trailers, Trailer Empire has the trailer perfectly matched to your load, job, and tow vehicle. With brands like Big Tex, Delta, Caliber, and more, they've got you covered at Trailer Empire. They also have enclosed dump truck and aluminum trailers. Don't worry about your credit because you're already approved. Put your hitch to good use. Call Trailer Empire today. 731-507-0555.
And online at Trailer-Empire.com. today I was going to talk to you a little bit just about the right Voices program, which is our third and fourth grade choir. Consists of about 40 of our students. These students try out early in the fall, and they commit to practicing two mornings a week for about 45 minutes those two mornings. And we perform a lot during the Christmas holiday, especially.
So obviously you talked about them. What kind of performances do they have coming up that the audience can look forward to?
Well, in December we do the Christmas tree lighting. We will sing for Rotary on December 2nd and several local businesses and nursing homes on that day. We sing at the Obion County Library Christmas Open House. We will sing for Chimes for Charity on December 6th. December 8th, we will be at the hospital Christmas party. And then they will also sing on December 14th after our kindergarten Christmas program.
So obviously plenty of opportunities to go and watch them. What other elementary choir groups do you lead that fans can go check out at some point?
Every grade level in school performs at some point during the school year. So our second grade has already done their program at Halloween. Pre-K will do a Christmas program the evening of December 12th. Kindergarten does a program during the school day on December 14th at 12:30 and 1:30. Our Voices also performs at those times on that day. It was first grade that's had their Halloween program. Second grade will perform in the spring on March 30th. And then our third and fourth grade spring musical that has been a tradition here for I would say at least 40 to 50 years that is over in the Civic Auditorium. That is in May, on May 12th.
So obviously you talk about a lot of different groups there, and you mention your Voices and your pre-K. How do you go about picking who performs in these different groups, or is it an optional thing that they can sign up for?
Voices is optional. These students have the opportunity to come and try out, especially since it's before school and several performances outside of school. It is, it's an obligation to them to perform. They sign a contract that they will participate and be a good citizen also in school. The grade level performances, all classes perform the songs. There are usually speaking parts in the third and fourth grade program. They try out for those special parts. The younger grades, I usually have teacher input to recommend certain students who aren't shy or would do well in front of a crowd.
So you mentioned obviously the optional aspect of Voices. How did you go about forming that, and when did that form, and what kind of gave you the idea for it?
Voices has been around for a long time. I'm really not sure how long it has been part of our elementary school community. There used to also be a program for it was second and third grade. And so then we had another program for fourth and fifth career. Grade. But when the program, when the fifth grade moved over to the middle school, we just focused then on a third and fourth grade choir. So it has been in existence for longer than just
when they went off to college. They chose to go that
since my career started.
So obviously with so many different performances coming up, what are kind of the biggest ones that people tend to highlight as they look back at the year with Voices?
They love, of course, the opportunity to sing for the nursing homes. I think that probably has the biggest impact on them because it's an environment that they normally do not go into. So they really see the impact that they have on those residents and how much they enjoy and love seeing these young kids come in.
Well, Ms. Stone, thank you so much for the time and good luck with your upcoming performances.
Thank you so much.
A lot of kiddos.
Waste.
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 You can make a difference. If it's time to dispose of sensitive electronic material, bring those used electronics to the Obion County Recycle Center on Mount Zion Road. For a small fee, bring your used TVs and monitors. Recycle all your paper documents with a small fee after the first 25 pounds. Looking to dispose of those fluorescent bulbs? According to the bulb size, it's only a small fee. Obion County Recycle Center.
You can make a difference.
And now, a word from another satisfied Johnson Heating and Air customer.
Well, I've known Donnie Johnson for about 40 years now, and he's done all my service work. He has put in 2 units, as I've never had any trouble. If I needed something, all I got to do is call him, and they're there to fix it. No problem at all. He has took on my family. He's took on my father-in-law, my aunt and uncle, the next-door neighbors, the church, the whole units for the church. He's done it all.
When you need HVAC service, Johnson Heating and Air is there for you. It's hard to stop a train.
Northwest Tennessee and Southern Kentucky, it's time for a career change. And we know the perfect place for you. Tyson Foods in Obion County. Tyson Foods is hiring, and it's easy to apply. Just stop by and see the friendly staff at the Tyson Foods Hiring Center in Union City. Tyson is currently hiring for general production and many other positions, and they are looking to fill all shifts. Come see the team at the Tyson Hiring Center, located off Real Foot Avenue in Union City. The Hiring Center is open Monday through Friday from 8 to 5. Come be a part of the Tyson team. Tyson Foods is an equal opportunity employer, including disability and veteran.
Are you in the market for a new car, but you don't know where to go? Well, folks, you're in luck. Just head to Kirk Nissan in Dyersburg and discover the largest new car inventory in a year. Kirk Nissan has a great selection of new and pre-owned cars and trucks just ready for you to test drive. Also, if you need tires, Kirk Nissan is having a tire sale. Buy 3 tires and get the 4th tire for $1.
Wow, that's amazing.
Kirk Nissan, 2700 Parr Avenue in Dyersburg, where we always do the right thing.
Back in the third quarter here at Haywood High School, 25-24 as we start the second half. Union City with a one-point lead over Haywood here on the road. On the right wing with it is Garrison, who floats it back out. And a three on the way from Murphy. Rims out, rebounded by Rogers. 7-10 to go, third quarter. Rogers flings it ahead, nearly stolen away by Woodland, but will go out of bounds. And it will stay Union City basketball. The ball will inbound as the teams have switched ends. Union City going right to left on your radio dial. Haywood left to right. Theobald gives it over to Snow on the left wing. Snow now attacks. I'm going to bring it back out to Bonds. Bonds had it poked loose. Watches it roll into the backcourt and will save it. And they'll say a backcourt violation. Union City screaming that it was tipped. And now the officials are going to talk about it. One said it was tipped. The others did not see it. And so they will agree that it was tipped, and it will be Union City basketball with 6:44 to go in the third. Theobald gives it to a cutting Rogers and saved by Theobald in the front court. The ball guarded by Woodland. Theobald trying to find help around a screen and an illegal screen on Ada Rogers. First foul on Rogers tonight. 25-24 as Woodland will bring it up ahead. Murphy putting the head down. A floater off the glass will not go. Rebound tapped around. Jones pulls it down in a tie-up and a jump ball. As Jones and Perkins getting heated a little bit. And Rogers and Theobald trying to calm Jones down. And I'm still not quite sure if they called anything. The ball is for you, is Union City's. Theobald is going to inbound. Some pressure here from Haywood. Theobald flings into Rogers. Rogers crossing over, brings it across the timeline. Gives up for Theobald, and Union City will set up the offense. Theobald driving down the left-hand side. Floater with the right hand wouldn't go. Rebound tipped loose. Theobald got it back. Back out Rogers. And Union City going to reset. Theobald back to, or Rogers back to Theobald at the elbow. Bonds now going to drive herself, and a whistle and a foul. So we'll go on Garrison will be her second. Again, something to remember. Bonds playing with three fouls herself. Steobald will inbound. 5:52 to go, third quarter. Inbounded for Bonds. 1 point Union City lead, 25-24. Bonds on the attack. Into the lane. Lays it up and in off the window. Bonds now with seven. And the lead is three for Union City, 27-24. 5:36 to go in the third. Woodland for Haywood. Flinging it on the left wing. Taylor in the corner. And a three for the tie. Would not drop for Garrison. But the offensive rebound to Murphy. Back out to Taylor. Woodland going to fire for three in the tie off the front iron. But another third chance for Haywood, but it sneaks out the Snow. Snow on the break. Up ahead to Theobald. Theobald ran past it. Swings it back out to Snow. Back to Bonds. Top of the key, a pump. Bonds, free throw line. Leaner off the window. Wouldn't go. Stick back up and in for Jones. The lead now five for Union City. 29-24. 4:56 to go as this one rims out for Woodland. Rebounded by Snow. Rogers now going to push in transition. Theobald on the left wing. Down low on the block. Jones, a turnaround two. Will drop for Debriana Jones. And a Commercial Bank timeout on the floor for Haywood as Union City comes out on a 6-0 run to take a 31-24 lead with 4:39 to go in the third quarter. Back in 30 seconds after the Commercial Bank timeout right here on the home of Union City Sports, Froggy 99.3.
This is Lynn Jenkins from Herman Jenkins Motors in Union City, Tennessee. On behalf of our entire staff, we want to say thank you for your continued support of our business. This Christmas season, may you and your family be blessed and enjoy the gift of one another. If you are looking for that special gift on wheels, stop by and see us at Herman Jenkins Motors, and we'll get you in a new Chrysler, Dodge, Jeep, or Ram that fits your needs. Also, don't forget to check us out online at HermanJenkinsUnionCity.com. Merry Christmas and Happy New Year's from all of us here at Herman Jenkins Motors.
31-24 as we resume action after the Haywood timeout. Union City with six straight points to open up a seven-point lead. And a whistle and a foul on Union City defensively. That's on Ajani Moss, will be her first. On the right wing is Garrison. Swinging it back to Woodland. Inside on the attack, Murphy, and a whistle and a traveling violation. Another turnover for Haywood. And now Union City with Moss, and Moss whistled for a travel to give it right back to Haywood. Haywood. 31-24, 4:20 to go, third quarter. Union City leading by seven. On the left wing, and a bump and a foul. That's going to go on Moss, will be number two. As Garrison plowed into her. Moss is going to check out, and Jayla Turner back into the game for Union City. Woodland on the left wing to Taylor. Back out to Woodland. On the right wing, it's Murphy. And it goes through the hands of Garrison in a turnover back to Union City with 4 minutes to go in the third quarter. As Rogers will check in, Turner will check out. So it's Jones, Snow, Bonds, Rogers, and Theobald for Union City. Inbounds for Rogers, hands off Theobald. Theobald now trying to dive into the lane. Drives, now backdoor pass to Jones, and Jones will finish off the window. Jones with a very quiet first half, just 2 points and now six here in the third quarter to give her eight on the night. New score, 33-24. The floater up and in off the window. Count it, and a foul for Zamaria Murphy.
Zamaria Murphy.
Murphy was 2 for 2 earlier tonight and leaves this one short. Rebound and a foul on the rebound as Rogers had brought it in. Garrison tagged with her third. 33-26, the new score. Here in the late stages of the third quarter. Theobald up ahead to Rogers. Around the screen. Rogers gives inside. Jones banging her way at the free throw line. Gives it off to Theobald. Crossing over. Back out to Rogers. Rogers into the lane. Works it out to Snow. A pump. Going to fire a long range three, and Snow in and out. It wouldn't drop. Rebounded by Woodland. 3 minutes to go in the third. 33-26. Woodland brings it ahead. Driving the baseline. A pull-up floater will get stuck for Garrison. Pinned between the rim and the glass. And Woodland trying to jump to knock it through, and they get one of the boys players to come out and knock it loose. So that's a jump ball, and the arrow is with Haywood in this situation. Taylor, inbounds for Woodland. Shot up, wouldn't go. Rebounded by Rogers. Theobald brings it across the timeline. On the left wing, Theobald aggressively driving. Picks up the dribble, now going to lean one off the glass and in for Marley Theobald. She found an opening and able to capitalize. Now 8 points on the night, and Union City leads by 9. Pass through the arms of Pugh in a turnover. Back to Union City. 3 players with 8 points tonight for Union City. Not one of them named Amari Bonds. 8 for Theobald, 8 for Snow, 8 for Jones. Theobald running the break, on the attack, flings it up and in, count it, and a foul. Marley Theobald with a potential 3-point play. Aggressive in transition, and it pays off for Union City. Theobald is 4 for 4 from the line. As Turner and Murphy going to check in for Union City. Murphy will get Theobald. Bonds makes way for Turner. And Theobald will convert the 3-point play. Now 11 points at Union City's first double-digit score tonight. ...38-26 is Haywood. Inbounds it. Union City by 12. 2:10 to go, third quarter. Union City has opened up a 12-point cushion. Woodland, guarded by Murphy, flings it on the right wing. A pump fake and a drive for Hall, and Hall comes up empty-handed. It rolls out of bounds, and will turn back over to Union City. Bonds and Theobald set to check back in. Claire Atwell has checked into the game, but will check out here. Theobald floats it in for Fair. Or make that Turner, rather, who's checked in. Or no, that was Fair, rather. Theobald probing. Gives to a cutting Bonds. Free throw line floater will rattle home and count it, and a foul. Amari Bonds going to get one more at the line. Can get into double figures with the free throw. Was the fourth foul on Garrison. Bonds will drill the 3-point play. She's now 3 for 3 from the line. She's got 10. And Union City opening up a 41-26 lead here in the third quarter. Hall floats it up the floor. Woodland on the breakaway. Woodland driving off the glass, wouldn't go, but a foul called on Union City. It's on Turner, will be her second. And Woodland heading to the free throw line was 2 for 2 earlier. 9 points on the evening for her. And drops in the first here. Two for two on that trip, now make it 11 for Woodland. And some changes for Union City. As Turner, Bonds, Theopold back into the game. And full court pressure from Haywood. The lead is 13, 41-28. Rogers going to make way. Inbounded to a wide open Snow. Theopold pushing it ahead for Union City. Hands off for Bonds. Bonds surveys the floor. Guarded by Taylor. 1:20 to go in the third. Bonds crosses over. Into the lane at the free throw line. Through contact, can't finish. Got her own rebound and is fouled on the putback. And two free throws coming for Amari Bonds. Tom Murphy will be her first foul. And Bonds will drill for the first of two shots. And drills the pair. And now with a game-high 12 for Union City. Woodland gives it down low to Perkins. Perkins working on Jones and a block and a foul on Jones. Will be three on Debriana Jones. And Perkins headed to the free throw line. Her first trip tonight. And can't get the first. Knocks down the second. On the score sheet now with 1 point. 43-29, a minute to go in the third. Theopold gives it the elbow to Bonds. Drives, pulls up, fires a long two, and drills one. Bonds with the 18-footer. She's got 14, and the lead is 16. Woodland floats it inside, pass tipped and stolen by Fair. Up ahead, Theopold on the attack. Theobald out to Fair, a long two, will drop for Jemiah Fair. 47-29, driving the other way, a little teardrop wouldn't go off the back iron for Haywood, rebound Bonds. Bonds with 14, Union City can hold it for the last shot of the quarter. Bonds on the attack, into the lane, off the window, and count it. Bonds has really picked up steam here in the third quarter, and the Union City has opened up a 20-point lead with 8.2 to play in the third quarter. And Bonds now 6 for 6 from the line. She's got 17 points, and the lead is 21 for Union City. 50-29. 8 seconds with Woodland at midcourt. Lost her dribble. Tried to float it down. Low a turnover with 2.8. As a hockey sub here for Coach Kobe. Full line change. The only one who doesn't come off is Debriana Jones. As Fair, Snow, and Bonds all check back in. 2 seconds. Bonds at midcourt. Floats one up at the horn that nearly went. But will bring us to the end of three. Union City by 21, 50-29 after a big third quarter for the Lady Golden Tornadoes. Back in 60 seconds with the fourth quarter on WWGY Fulton, Froggy 99.3 in Union City.
This is Larry Sherwood, administrator of Ural Vine County Nursing and Rehab. So now the unthinkable has happened. You are not prepared to hear these words, and you are hoping that you would never hear them. Your mom or dad needs the services of a nursing home. Now what? Call Obion County Nursing and Rehab. We are here to help. You have questions? We have the answers that will help guide you into making the right decisions. So come meet our family who cares for your family at Obion County Nursing and Rehab, 1084 East County Home Road, Union City, Tennessee.
Make every season count. Start with Nutrien Ag Solutions. Every season starts by choosing the right seed for your unique growing conditions. Nutrien Ag Solutions carries a wide selection of top-performing seed brands, including Dyna-Grow Seed, to get the most out of your acres. You also have the advantage of working with local seed experts, crop consultants, and agronomists, ready to provide a custom recommendation to help you make the right decision every time. In Union City, visit Nutrien Ag Solutions at 530 North 5th Street. That's Nutrien Ag Solutions in Union City.
A 25-5 third quarter run for Union City opens up a 21-point cushion as they lead it 50-29 as we head into the final 8 minutes. Union City will start the fourth quarter with Theopold, Bonds, Snow, Fair, and Jones for Union City. Bonds on the right wing. Crossing over, back out to Fair. Trying to lob it down low, pass deflected, stolen by Perkins, and nearly stolen back by Theobald. It leaks out to Jones. Jones back to Theobald and back to Bonds. Bonds going to fire for three. Can't get it to go. Rebound knocked out of bounds off of Hall, and it will be Union City basketball with 7:36 to go in regulation. Inside to Bonds off the screen, and Bonds lays it up and in. She has caught fire in the second half and extends the lead to 23. 19 points for Amari Bonds after just 7 in the first half. Top of the key, Woodland. They give it on the block. Perkins will kick it back out for Murphy. Top of the key to Woodland. Union City giving a bit of a zone look here. Trying to lob it inside to Perkins. Pass tipped and stolen by Theobald. And a tie-up with Hall and a foul on Hall. First foul on Hall. 52-29 and puts Union City over the limit and into the bonus. And so Marley Theobald, who is 5-for-5 from the line tonight, will shoot the 1-and-1. And Theobald stays perfect. And we'll go 2-for-2. And it's 7-for-7 tonight with 13 points. Traveling violation on the other end against Haywood. We'll turn it back over to Union City. 54-29, 6:56 to go, and Union City exploding in the third quarter to blow this thing open. Theobald around the screen, gives in the corner. Rogers pumps. Rogers, top of the key to Snow, will fire for three with space, and in and out it wouldn't drop. Rebounded by Taylor. On the right wing, it's Murphy. They leak it back out to Taylor. Around the screen. Now down low. Pass deflected and will be knocked out of bounds by Debriana Jones. As Turner going to check back in, out comes Theobald. They throw it in for Woodland. 6:26 to go in the game. On the right wing, and a three on the way from Woods, who's just checked in, will knock it down. Asia Woods, the freshman, drilling a trifecta, will cut the lead to 22. 6:12 to play. Bonds, top of the key. Trying to find Turner, does so. Right wing to Rogers. Rogers will drive, a bump and a foul. That's going to go on Woods and will send Ada Rogers to the line for a 1-and-1. Rogers 1-of-2 on her first trips. On her first trip earlier tonight. And we'll drop in the first on this trip. Now 2 points for Ada Rogers. 2-for-2 at the line. And a whistle and a traveling violation on Woods is going to turn it back over to Union City. 56-32, Union City by 24. As Fair going to check in at the next dead ball. Bonds walking it across with 5:48 to play. Working on Woodland. Screen by Jones. Bonds driving into the lane, off the glass and in. 21 for Amari Bonds, and the lead is 26. Lofted into the corner for Woods. Back out to Woodland. On the left wing, and a long three ball. Nothing but nylon for Zamaria Murphy. Commercial Bank timeout taken by Coach Kobe. 5:21 to play. 58-35, Union City leads by 23. Back in 60 seconds on the home of Union City Sports, Froggy 99.3.
Today's economy, small businesses and consumers need every advantage to survive and get ahead. That's where community banks come in. Hi, I'm Tim Shanks at Commercial Bank and Trust Company. We give you the chance to succeed by providing the tools to start a small business, buy a home, fund a retirement, and fuel your dreams. Stop by and see us and let us show you why community banks build better communities. When banking matters, it matters who you bank with. Commercial Bank and Trust Company, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
American Roofing Soft Wash is your roof cleaning expert. For all kinds of pressure washing, contact KB at American Roofing Soft Wash. They also do patios, driveways, gutters, sidewalks, vinyl siding, semi-trucks, trailers, and heavy equipment. American Roofing Soft Wash specializes in dirty roofs, and by cleaning your roof, it'll preserve the shingles, adding 2 to 5 years of life. Check them out on Facebook at American Roofing Soft Wash or call KB at 731-636-9700. American Roofing Soft Wash, making roofs look great again.
Bonds driving down, length of the floor, and is fouled. And Bonds heading back to the free throw line for more free throw attempts. She is 6 for 6 tonight. And now make it 7 for 7. And with that one, 8 for 8 and 23 points to boot. Has really gotten going in the second half. And a big reason why this lead has ballooned to a 25-point Union City cushion. As Woodland will bring it up. Over on the left wing for Murphy. Murphy on the drive. Little floater, wouldn't drop, rolls out of bounds. And is going to turn back over to Union City. Bounded for Bonds. Now they swing it back to Theobald. 5 minutes to play in the basketball game. Theobald crosses back over to Bonds. Bonds crossing over into the lane on the attack, and a foul going to go on Woodland. Woodland picks up her second. And Bonds will shoot her 9th and 10th free throw attempts, and finally a miss. The second, this one will drop. 9 of 10 from the stripe, 24 for Amari Bonds. As Hall checks out for Haywood, 61-35, Union City. Up big here late in the fourth quarter, 4:42 to play. Right wing, Asia Woods. Lost it, stolen away by Bonds. Bonds loses it. Still loose on the floor. Woodland, and Bonds comes out of the scrum with it. Over on the left wing, Theobald on the attack and is going to get fouled. And we'll head to the free throw line as Union City now in the double bonus the rest of the way. Second on Murphy, and Marley Theobald back to the line. She is 7 of 7 so far tonight, and now 8 of 8. She's got 14. and can't get that one to go. Rebounded by Pugh. Haywood the other way. Woodland stretching and can't finish, but a foul called. And free throws coming for Kamaria Woodland. It's on Jemiah Fair as Woodland can't get the first to drop. Now 4-5 with 11 points, the top scorer for Haywood tonight. We'll make that Murphy the top scorer. Can tie Murphy. But will not on this trip. Rebound recovered by Theobald. 62-35. Up to Bonds on the left wing. In the corner, Snow. Back out to Theobald. Theobald in the lane. Gives down low. Jones a baseline. Two will not go. Rebound by Marley. Theobald in a tie-up with Pugh. And the arrow is with Haywood with 4:07 to play. Woodland, top of the key. Gives on the left wing for Murphy. Murphy on the attack, barreling into the lane. Off the window, it wouldn't go. Rebound knocked out of bounds off of Haywood. And will be Union City basketball with 3:49 to play. Theobald flings it in, pass deflected, and it will be stolen by Haywood. Murphy puts it up off the window, won't go. Rebounded by Jones. Theobald pushing it ahead for Union City. 3:38 to go in the corner to Snow. On the left wing, driving the baseline. Snow lost her dribble, and it will turn back over to Haywood with 3.5 to play. Into the front court, Woodland. Down low, pass deflected by Snow as Pugh was standing wide open on the block, but Snow disrupting the entry pass. And a turnover back, or will stay with Haywood. Lobbed in. Woodland, floater with the right hand, off the back iron, not good. Rebound by Pugh, back out to Murphy. Murphy, a pull-up long two, won't go. Put back up and in by Woodland. 62-37 with 3:10 to play. Inbounded to Bonds. Weaving her way through traffic. Bonds on the attack, lays it up and will finish. Bonds with 26, a game high tonight. 2:53 to go, fourth quarter. Coach Kilby with a huge sub coming as that three ball will not drop for Garrison. Rebound by Theobald. Up the floor to Snow. Snow trying to hang on, nearly lost it. Flings it back out to Bonds, top of the key. Bonds on the attack, down low to Snow, or to Jones. Jones couldn't finish. Rebounded by Wilkes for Haywood. Haven't seen her since the first quarter. A pass deflected and a steal by Theobald. Theobald going to slow it down. 64-37. 2:15 to go. Snow, a right wing three on the way. Will not drop. Rebounded by Wilkes. Wilkes on the right wing. Gives it in the corner. Garrison. 2 minutes to play. A top of the key three from Murphy. Won't go. Recovered by Woodland. Woodland, a right-handed floater, short, rebounded by Theobald. And a stoppage, and they're going to bring on the subs that Coach Kobe's had at the bench for quite a bit. So it's Jamari Cox, Brooklyn Murphy, Claire Atwell, Jemiah Fair, and Jayla Turner all checking into the game for Union City with 1:52 to go. And here comes subs for Haywood as Macy Farrell, Akila Jones, Kiara Worrells, Mackenzie Gaines, and Asia Woods all checking in for Haywood. Murphy will bring it up for Union City. 1:45 to play, fourth quarter. Murphy to Atwell. Atwell back out to Fair. Turner, top of the key, gives to Cox. Cox trying to hold up for Atwell. Gives it off to Atwell. Atwell going to try a right wing three. That one won't go. rolls out of bounds, and we'll give it back to Haywood. They say it was tipped by Haywood, so inbounded for Cox from Union City. Back out to Murphy. Murphy on the attack. Picks up her dribble, gives it off to Cox. Back out to Turner. Turner now going to drive. Back out to Atwell. Atwell to Fair. 1 minute to play. Fair around the screen. Now going to heave up a three of her own. This one's short. Rebound corralled by Haywood. Deflected by Atwell, nearly stolen. Will go out of bounds off of Haywood and with Union City basketball. Atwell will inbound. Gives in to Turner. Turner over to Cox. 50 seconds to play. In the corner with Fair. Back out to Cox. She's going to fire a right wing three. Won't go. Rebound. Tapped loose and saved back into Turner. Now to Atwell. Atwell with a nice pump fake. Gives it over to Cox. 33 seconds. Down low. Wide open is Murphy who lays it up and in. 66-37 Union City by 29. Or by 29. Woods lost her dribble. Saves it. Pass deflected. And will roll out of bounds and stay with Haywood with 15.3 to go. As Lakaya Gordon going to check in, out comes Jemiah Fair. Inbounded for Farrell, and a turnover and a steal by Murphy. Murphy picks up the dribble, gives off to Turner, will fire a right wing three that is whistled off for a traveling violation. Woods will bring it up and dribble out the final 2 seconds, and that'll do it. 66-37, the final score as Union City rolls in the second half and wins by 29 here on the road and will improve to 4-7 on the season. We'll take a break. We'll come back, crank up the Five Seasons Men's Shop postgame show and get you ready for the boys' game coming up here in just a little bit as well. Stay tuned. More coming right after this on the home of Union City Sports, Froggy 99.3.
At Reynolds Brothers Tire Company in Union City and Martin, they carry Cooper, Michelin, and Goodyear tires. In fact, they carry all major brands and many private brands, too. They even go the extra mile for their customers with a service package that includes road hazard, fix-free flats, and lifetime balancing. Reynolds Brothers, nobody beats their customer service. Reynolds Brothers Tire Company, 400 East Church Street in Union City and 505 North Lindell Street in Martin.
For your next car or truck, come see Jerry Ward Autoplex in Union City. Jerry Ward and his all-star team have a lot filled with pre-owned small, mid-sized, and full-sized cars, SUVs, and nice trucks, too. And if they don't have the right size, they'll find it for you. No matter what you're looking for, score your next ride at Jerry Ward Autoplex, Real Foot Avenue in Union City, or online at jerrywardautoplex.com. Like Jerry always says, don't dream it, drive it. Be a winner with Jerry Ward Autoplex in Union City.
Five Seasons Men's Shop, they carry key brand names. Southern Marsh, Vineyard Vines, Fish Hippie, Michael Kors, and lots more. From suits to sportswear, from shoes to tuxedos, Five Seasons is the store where you'll find it all for the man who wants more. Remember, Five Seasons has big and tall sizes up to 4X and youth sizes as well. Be sure and follow Five Seasons Men's Shop on Facebook for daily specials. Five Seasons Men's Shop in Union City and Martin. Walk in a man, walk out the man.
For all your trailer needs, Trailer Empire in Union City is your go-to source. From small trailers to big trailers, Trailer Empire has the trailer perfectly matched to your load, job, and tow vehicle. With brands like Big Tex, Delta, Caliber, and more, they've got you covered at Trailer Empire. They also have enclosed dump truck and aluminum trailers. Don't worry about your credit because you're already approved. Put your hitch to good use. Call Trailer Empire today. 731-507-0555.
And online at Trailer-Empire.com.
This 37 winners over Haywood as we get ready for the boys game coming up as the two teams warm up. But looking at the final stats presented by American Roofing Softwash for Union City, Amari Bonds leading all scores with a 26-point night. Marley Theobald in double figures as well with 14. Debriana Jones and Adasia Snow both finished with 8. Ada Rogers and Ajani Moss chip in 3, while Brooklyn Murphy and Jemiah Fair put in a deuce as well. For Haywood, Kamaria Woodland leads Haywood with 13 points. Amaria Murphy adds 12. On the other side, it's Megan Garrison with 6. Alana Perkins with 1. And Asia Woods with 1. Looking at the final box score tonight, Union City led by 7 at the end of 1, 18 to 11. And then Haywood outscored them 13 to 7 in the second quarter to cut the lead to 1 at 25-24 heading into the locker room. And then Union City exploding in the third quarter, a 25-5 run, and they led 50-29 at the end of three quarters, and then one going away 66-37, outscoring Haywood 16-8 in the final frame. Union City back in action. They'll head home for the final game before the Christmas holiday as they host Trinity Christian on Tuesday night. Our on-air coverage starts at 5:45 with tip-off coming at 6. Haywood back in action on Monday to play Gibson County in the Gibson County pre-Christmas tournament. Boys game tipping off here in about 9 minutes. We'll take another quick break. When we come back, we'll preview that one as Union City getting ready to take on Haywood in the second half of our doubleheader. Boys game coming up right after this on the home of Union City Sports, Froggy 99.3.
This is Larry Sherwood, administrator of your Obion County Nursing and Rehab. So now the unthinkable has happened. You are not prepared to hear these words, and you were hoping that you would never hear them. Your mom or dad needs the services of a nursing home. Now what? Call Obion County Nursing and Rehab. We are here to help. You have questions? We have the answers that will help guide you into making the right decisions. So come meet our family who cares for your family at Obion County Nursing and Rehab, 1084 East County Home Road, Union City, Tennessee.
Are you looking for an early learning program that not only gives your child a head start on their learning journey, but also works with the entire family? If so, Northwest Tennessee Head Start, Early Head Start is excited to share that they are accepting applications for the 2022-23 school year. Don't miss out on this opportunity. Northwest Tennessee Head Start, with locations in McKenzie, Paris, Union City, Troy, Huntingdon, Tiptonville, Dresden, Kenton, Puryear, Milan, Brewston, Humboldt, Trenton, Camden, and Jackson. To enroll your child today, text in Enroll to 68683. That's enroll to 68683.
McLean Power Systems of Trenton is hiring for manufacturing positions. From welders to assemblers and everything in between, they have the perfect opportunity for you. At McLean Power Systems, they understand how important work-life balance is. Team members can work 5 days a week or volunteer for as much overtime as they'd like. With positions available on first, second, and third shifts, you can work on a schedule that benefits you and your family. To apply, text the word POWER to 30605. McLean Power Systems is an equal opportunity employer.
For all your trailer needs, Trailer Empire in Union City is your go-to source. From small trailers to big trailers, Trailer Empire has the trailer perfectly matched to your load, job, and tow vehicle. With brands like Big Tex, Delta, Caliber, and more, they've got you covered at Trailer Empire. They also have enclosed dump truck and aluminum trailers. Don't worry about your credit because you're already approved. Put your hitch to good use. Call Trailer Empire today. 731-507-0555. And online at trailer-empire.com.
Show presented by Tyson Foods in Obion County and Herman Jenkins Motors as Union City getting set to take on Haywood in the second portion of our doubleheader tonight. Union City coming in on the boys' side off a loss last night to South Gibson in a game defensively they couldn't, or offensively, they just continue to struggle in the absence of Malachi Brooks. Joseph Lattice missed Tuesday's game against Henry County, but back in the lineup on Friday, and it just was not enough as Union City struggled to create any offense. Only 5 threes, and Coach Sisko says the goal is to make 10 a game with this team and just have not been able to hit that since Malachi Brooks went down with an injury. They played well enough to win, just stayed within striking distance, were always down, it seemed like 8, 9, perhaps 10 points, but they could never quite get over an 8-point hump, and that was how Union City fell in a 55-45 loss last night. They did force 15 turnovers and committed less than 10, but it was not enough because they just could never capitalize on these turnovers. And then offensive rebounding, they played well on that side of the floor as well, but again, just not enough. They did not do a good enough job capitalizing on their second chance opportunities. A big third quarter from South Gibson as the Hornets pulled away and Union City fell 55-45. Last time these two teams met, it was a big second half from Haywood, who pulled away 40-25 with the final two over the final two quarters to win 67-56. They even led at halftime. It was a really fun opening half between the two teams, but Union City could not hang in long enough, as Union City could not maintain the physicality that Haywood brought to the table, and the Tomcats able to pull away. And that's one thing Coach Sisko wants to see more of. He wants to see this team be the aggressors and instigate the contact and be the ones who dictate the pace. But obviously trying to kind of bounce back after a loss on Tuesday and a loss on Friday, as this team really shorthanded without Malachi Brooks, really trying to get anything going offensively. But defensively tonight, they've got to find a way to slow down Tylan Chapman. He led all scorers with 25 points the last time these two teams met back in January. Looking at Haywood, they come in on a really hot streak. They've won four straight. They're playing really good ball, blowing out usual power in boys basketball. Jackson Southside 85-51 last night. And Union City obviously knows what they're getting into tonight with Haywood. They've seen them once already this season, and this is a really solid basketball team that is off to a 7-2 start to the season and trying to keep rolling after having a solid season last year. They've got some high expectations, bringing a lot back from last year. Went to the Region 8 AAA semifinals. They've got seven seniors on this year's team, so expectations are high for this Tomcat team. For Union City, let's take a look at the keys to the game, brought to you by Jerry Ward Autoplex. These keys to the game are brought by the guys at Jerry Ward Autoplex. Score your next set of keys from Jerry and the guys today. First, let's take a look at the rebounding stats. Union City have got to get good production on the offensive glass. That's going to be a huge key tonight. They cannot give this athletic Haywood team second chance opportunities. They've got to rebound on the defensive end. They've also got to create some second chances themselves, and tonight they've got to cash those in. They've got to take care of the basketball. Haywood is going to play physical. They're going to play disruptive basketball. They're going to try to make Union City turn it over and give them extra chances in transition to make some big plays. Union City cannot give them that. They've got to take care of the basketball here tonight. And then finally, knock down some threes. That's one way to stay in the game against a really good opponent in Haywood. You've got to give yourself a chance with some three balls. Coach Sisko said the goal is to make 10 a game. And tonight, another final fourth key to the game: find another scorer. Find your go-to guy. That's kind of one thing we've talked about. Union City kind of still searching for an identity post Malachi Brooks, who's out until probably January. You've got to find someone who can be your go-to guy in clutch minutes, whether that is Joseph Lattis, DJ Robinson. Somebody has got to step up and help give this team a spark offensively. They've got to move the ball. They've got to rotate it. Find open guys. We saw a lot of nice cuts and backdoor passes to Jalen Lewis from CJ Davis last night. But Union City's got to get into the paint. They've got to be aggressive. They've got to attack. And they've got to set up some open three looks for themselves tonight against a really athletic team that comes in at 7-2 and red hot with winning their last four games and four or five of their last six as well. So should be a fun night of basketball. Union City trying to snap a three-game skid as they take on Haywood here on the road in Brownsville. It is the Tornado pregame show on Froggy 99.3, presented by Tyson Foods in Obion County and Herman Jenkins Motors. Those keys to the game brought to you by Jerry Ward Autoplex. Score your next set of keys from Jerry and the guys today. We'll take a break. When we come back, we'll have the Nutrient Ag Solutions starting lineups and the opening tip-off. Stay tuned. More coming right after this on the home of Union City Sports, Froggy 99.3.
Foundation. At Allen Searcy Builder Contractors, they know that it's the essential part of having a successful project, but it's also an important element in each relationship with their clients. Understanding and protecting the interests of each business they serve is why Allen Searcy continues to be the source for major commercial projects in our area for over 40 years. Allen Searcy Builder Contractors can help you with your project from concept and design all the way to construction. Call 885-7633 or go to allencearcy.com.
The Citizen Bank online banking allows their customers secure and convenient access to their accounts using the internet anytime. With some of their online banking functions, you can access and print information on all of your accounts, including loans, confirm your deposits, withdrawals, and checks cleared, view deposits and checks cleared, and receive email alerts. Now that's taking care of business for you. The Citizens Bank, Hickman, Fulton, and Union City. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Have you heard the news? Kaiser Pharmacy has a new gift shop, Miles and Bishop. You've always known us for our unique baby gifts, but we decided it's time to expand and offer gifts for all occasions. While you're here shopping for others, be sure to pick up a little happy for yourself. You deserve it. Come see Olivia Riley at Miles and Bishop, where the gift wrapping and service is free. Remember, it's now Miles and Bishop inside Kaiser Pharmacy in Union City.
Remember Shoe Shack in Union City for name brand shoes and boots, both ladies and men's clothing, and the trendiest accessories, hats, purses, bags, and lots more. Come shop Shoe Shack for exciting arrivals for the season. Shoe Shack can clothe your entire family from head to toe. Be sure and follow Shoe Shack in Union City on Facebook for their very latest arrivals. For every season, please shop local and shop Shoe Shack in Union City, 2800 East Ruleford Avenue in Union City.
Back in Haywood High School as the Nutrien-X starting lineups being announced here. Let's take a look at the five for Union City. They will start like this at four. To senior number one, Jalen Lewis. At guard, another senior number two, DJ Robinson. At guard, a junior number four, CJ Davis. At four, a junior number 15, Joseph Lattice. And in at another guard, a sophomore number 22, Ben Kale. Haywood will start like this at guard, a 6-foot senior, number one, Tylen Chapman. At center, a 6-foot-7 senior, number three, Janaris Snipe. At guard, a 6-foot-3 senior, number two, Jamari Person. At guard, a 6-foot-2 junior, number 22, Jakari Komaj. And at guard, a 6-foot-4 sophomore, number 13, Jabayan Snipe. Haywood led by head coach Chapman, and they come in at 7-2 on the season. Union City, led by head coach Shane Sisko, they come in at 3-7 on the season. Union City will wear the gold-on-gold road combination with purple lettering and numbering and white trim. Haywood will wear the home white-on-white with purple numbering and lettering. It will be Janaris Snipe to jump for Haywood. It will be Jalen Lewis for Union City. Union City will go left to right on your radio dial. Haywood will go right to left. Lewis wins the opening tap, and Robinson will bring it ahead into the front court, and we are underway here at Haywood. Left wing for C.J. Davis, who's going to drive inside at the free throw line, brings it back out to Kale. Kale around the screen, spins at the free throw line, dishes out to Lattice. Lattice out to Robinson, who will drive inside. Floater with the left hand, won't drop. Rebound, Jalen Lewis. Lewis on the stick back, now going to bring it back out. Weaving his way, kicks it out to Kale. Back top of the key, Robinson. Robinson on the attack. Swings it out to Kale. Kale crossing over, top of the key. And this one thrown away in a turnover by Union City. Miscommunication trying to find Davis. And now Haywood with the basketball. No score, 7:20 to go in the first quarter. Person on the left wing for Haywood. Give it on the right wing. Jabayan Snipe back over to Person. Back Jabayan Snipe. He'll fire a right wing three off the back iron, and Kale the rebound for Union City. Kale pushing the tempo on the right wing. Gets top of the key to Robinson. Robinson to Lattice. Lattice back to Robinson. Right wing. Robinson. Top of the key. Swings right wing to Kale. Kale crossing over. Now on the drive. Spinning into the lane. Kicks out to Davis. A pump fake. Davis pumps again. Now swings it back out to Robinson. 6:30 to go. No score. Robinson will fire a three. That one left short. Rebound corralled by Jabayan Snipe. And they say Snipe stepped on the line, and a turnover back to Union City. So can Union City cash in here? No score, 6:22 to go, first quarter. Robinson floats it in to Davis. Davis drives, spins, picks up the dribble, back out to Robinson. Robinson into the lane, lays it up and in, and Union City breaks the opening deadlock. 2-0 Union City, 6:05 to go, first quarter. It is Chapman, top of the key for Haywood. Guarded by Davis, flings it out to Bryan Snipe. Person steps into a right wing triple and buries it. Person gives Haywood a 3-2 lead, 5:47 to go, first quarter. Kale now on the attack. Spins, had space for a moment, now runs into some defense, kicks it out to Gladys. Kale. Left wing for Lattice. Gives up to Robinson. Robinson lost his dribble, stolen away. On the break by Comage. On the attack, Comage off the glass and in. And Haywood will take a 5-2 lead after the Comage bucket. Lattice on the right wing. Pass tipped and nearly stolen by Chapman. .458 to go, first quarter. Lattice inbounding. They're giving it back to Robinson, who inbounded. Robinson now driving into the lane through contact. Lays it in with the left hand. 4 points early for DJ Robinson. Cuts the lead to 1, 5-4. 4:40 to go. First quarter, a three on the right wing. Wouldn't go. Rebound by Lewis. Robinson going to push the tempo. Crossing over. Kicks out to Kale. Back inside. Lewis will push it up and in with the right hand. Jalen Lewis with a nice bucket for Union City through contact, and the Golden Tornadoes retake the lead 6-5. Down inside on the block, Snipe, a turnaround floater will drop in for Janaris Snipe. And Haywood retakes the lead 7-6. Lattice on the right wing, driving into the lane. Kicks it back out to Kale. 4 minutes to go, first quarter. Kale crosses over, nifty dribbling. Into the lane, picks up the dribble. Back out to Robinson. A pump, lost his dribble. Around a screen. Robinson with a right-handed floater that won't go. Lewis couldn't corral the stick back, and it's rebounded by Comage. Up the floor to Chapman. Chapman along the baseline. Floater from the left hand wouldn't go. Kale the rebound for Union City. Kale to Robinson, 7-6. Haywood by one. Lattice, a right wing three, left short. Rebound by Bryan Snipe. Snipe will bring it ahead himself. Swings it over. A three for Comage will not go. Rebound tipped up. Rebounded by Lewis. Robinson. Over to Kale on the right wing. In the corner to Lattice. Lattice on the attack. Floats it over to Davis. Davis spinning into the lane. And is whistled for a traveling violation that will turn it back over to Haywood. As LaKendrick Phillips going to check in, out comes Comage. And so Person calls out the play. 2:52 to go, first quarter, 7-6, Haywood by one. Phillips, top of the key, gives inside, a turnaround two, will not go, rebounded by Chapman. Chapman steps out, fires for three. Left it short, another stick back, and this one will roll in for Jadarius Snipe. He's got four. 9-6, Haywood's lead is three. Robinson pumps, and a whistle. And a traveling violation on DJ Robinson in another Union City turnover. Person. Gives inside Chapman at the elbow. Chapman along the baseline. Dishes outside. A three ball on the way. Will not drop. Lattice the rebound. Robinson into the lane. Kicks out to Kale. A pump for Kale. He'll bring it back out. And a whistle and a foul going to go on Phillips. It'll be his first and the first foul of the night with 2 minutes to go in the first quarter. And a commercial bank timeout on the floor by Haywood. 2 minutes to go, first quarter. Topcats lead 9-6 back in 30 seconds on the home of Union City Sports.
Waste.
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 You can make a difference. If it's time to dispose of sensitive electronic material, bring those used electronics to the Obion County Recycle Center on Mount Zion Road. For a small fee, bring your used TVs and monitors. Recycle all your paper documents with a small fee after the first 25 pounds. Looking to dispose of those fluorescent bulbs? According to the bulb size, it's only a small fee. Obion County Recycle Center.
You can make a difference.
Nine to six, midway through the first quarter, as Union City trailing Haywood 9-6. 2 minutes to go in this opening frame. Finn Frankham and Jack Tully check into the game for Union City. Frankham picks up his dribble, floats it over to Davis, nearly tipped and recovered by Davis, trying to escape pressure, and it's stolen away by Haywood. On the attack, and Colmage to the rim, and a foul on Davis. Two shots coming. Make that person, rather. First on C.J. Davis. As Person cannot knock down the first. And Person will knock down the second. Now 4 points for him. 10-6 is the new score. As that shot wouldn't go for Union City. Rebound corralled by Robert McAfee, who's just checked in. Chapman into the corner, Person along the baseline, flings it back out to Chapman. Into the lane, Chapman, floater with the left hand, left short, rebound, rolls out of bounds, and off of Haywood and back to Union City. And they're changing the call. They're going to say Haywood basketball. Chapman. Kicks it out to Person. Down inside, they dish it back out to Chapman. Chapman pulls up, contested, long two and a tough shot. Drops in for Chapman, and it's 12-6 Haywood, 1:04 to go in the first quarter. Robinson into the lane, kicks out to Kale. Handing it off to Davis. 50 seconds to go in the opening frame. Davis driving, working on McAfee. Trying to fling it over for Kale, but it's stolen away by Person. Person up ahead. Chapman runs into a wall of gold jerseys, and they say he stepped on the line in a turnover back to Haywood. D'Angelo Monroe going to check in here. Out comes C.J. Davis. Robinson, top of the key with 30 seconds to go. On the right wing, it's Kale. Kale spins away from two defenders. Left-handed floater wouldn't go. Rebound ripped down by Janaris Snipe. 19 seconds with Chapman. Into the front court, kicks out to Snipe. Back across to McAfee. Down low on the block, it's Phillips. Back out to McAfee. And again, Phillips in the corner. A breakdown for Union City as Phillips will drop in a trifecta. 15-6, and that'll bring us to the end of one. Union City trails by 9, 15-6. We'll take a break. We will come back with the second quarter after this on the home of Union City Sports.
Now, a word from another satisfied Johnson Heating and Air customer.
Well, I've known Donnie Johnson for about 40 years now, and he's done all my service work. He has put in two units, as I've never had any trouble. If I needed something, all I got to do is call him, and they're there to fix it. No problem at all. He has took on my family. He's took on my father-in-law, my aunt and uncle, the next-door neighbors, the church, the whole units for the church. He's done it all.
When you need HVAC service, Johnson Heating and Air is there for you. It's hard to stop a train.
Are you in the market for a new car, but you don't know where to go? Well, folks, you're in luck. Just head to Kirk Nissan in Dyersburg and discover the largest new car inventory in a year. Kirk Nissan has a great selection of new and pre-owned cars and trucks just ready for you to test drive. Also, if you need tires, Kirk Nissan is having a tire sale. Buy three tires and get the fourth tire for $1.
Wow, that's amazing.
Kirk Nissan, 2700 Parr Avenue in Dyersburg, where we always do the right thing.
Second quarter getting underway as Union City trails 15-6. Person will bring it into the front court for Haywood. A dish out to Phillips. Phillips on the attack, into the lane, lays it up, lays it in, count it, and a foul. It's just the first foul on Lattice. Phillips with 5 points headed to the line. Just three total fouls have been called here in the first half as Phillips converts the old-fashioned three-point play. And a steal nearly in the backcourt. Robinson saves it, trying to throw it inbounds off of Phillips. Phillips on the attack, can't finish this time, but a foul on Lewis on the contest. And so two more foul shots coming for LaKendrick Phillips. And Phillips can't get that one to drop. Phillips goes to 1 of 2 on that trip. 2 for 3 overall. Lattice stolen away on the breakaway. Up to the basket. Comage will lay it in. And Union City going to take a Commercial Bank timeout as Haywood on a 6-0 run to start the second quarter. They now lead 21-6 with 7:23 to go in quarter number two. So we'll keep it right here. Let's take a look at some scores on the Reynolds Brothers Tire Company scoreboard from around the area. Gibson County picking up a 74-33 win over Henry County on the road today. We mentioned Bradford Girls picking up a 46-24 win over Halls earlier today, and some scores from yesterday as it was Fayette Ware picking up a 60-48 win over Bolivar. Some more pressure here from Haywood as that's caused Union City some problems in the second quarter. Up ahead to Davis on the left wing. Davis to Robinson, 21-6. Haywood leading it by 15. Robinson had it poked away, stolen away. McAfee on the break, up ahead to Phillips. Tipped down and knocked away by Robinson. Homage will inbound for Chapman. Inbounds for Phillips, and now on the block to Snipe. Snipe trying to back his way into the lane. Floats it back out to Chapman. And a whistle and a foul on Davis. .644 to go second quarter. Haywood basketball with a 21-6 lead. Inbounding for Phillips. They'll give it inside to Snipe, who will kick it out to Comage off the screen, and a three will drop in for Jakari Comage. 7 points for him and more pressure from Haywood. And a whistle and a foul on McAfee. As Lewis is going to check out. And just going to inbound here. Monroe with the basketball, trying to bring it up the floor, working against this pressure, and a double dribble against Union City. We'll turn it over to Haywood, and the Tomcats going to try and extend their 24-6 lead, 6:20 to go in the second quarter. Inbounded for Phillips. On the attack, and a whistle, no whistle rather. A rebound off the attempt by Phillips is put back up and in by Devarian Pierce. And Haywood leads by 20, and another near Union City turnover. And Coach Cisco will take a commercial bank timeout. 6:07 to go, second quarter. Union City trailing by 20, 26-6, back in 30 seconds on the home of Union City Sports.
Looking for a career change? You should join the friendly team at Tyson Foods in Union City. Apply now for general production positions up to $21.90 plus a shift premium. Tyson offers excellent benefits, including paid vacation, company matching 401k plans, and more. Apply online anytime at Tyson.com/careers, in person at 2800 Tyson Drive, or Monday through Friday, 8 to 5 at the Tyson Hiring Center off Real Foot in Union City. Tyson Foods in Obion County is hiring now. Tyson Foods is an equal opportunity employer, including disability and veterans.
Defense! 26-6 as we resume action. Haywood up big early on Union City. 6:07 to go in the first half. DJ Robinson back in for Union City. Kale over to Robinson, who floats it ahead. Pass tipped and a steal by Comage. In the corner with Phillips. Phillips on the attack. Pushes it up and an offensive foul called on Phillips. As C.J. Davis standing in to take the charge. And so into the game comes Caden Pirtle for Haywood. Out comes Phillips with those two fouls. Finn Frankham checks in. Out comes Joseph Lattice. Robinson flings it ahead for Lewis. Lewis on the attack. Euro step move to the basket and finishing off the window. Jalen Lewis will halt the run. Union City had a good first quarter early, trying to work the clock and slow down the pace, but Haywood has sped things up here in the second quarter. Homage will hand off for Snipe. Down low, wide open is Snipe, who lays it up and in. Jacarius Snipe will finish at the rim for Haywood, and another near steal knocked out of bounds off of Haywood. Lattice is going to check back in comes Frankham. Robinson across the timeline. 28-8, Haywood by 20. Davis out to Lattice. Lattice going to try a tray ball. Left it short, got his own rebound. Out to Davis, top of the key. Kale going to fire from long distance, and that one well short. Rebound control by the Tomcats. Off and running is Hayes. Top of the key is Comage. 4:40 to go in the first half. Rolls out of bounds. A turnover off the leg of Janaris Snipe. Robinson trying to break the pressure, gets it across the timeline. Top of the key on the drive, and a whistle and a foul on Haywood. It's Davian Pierce picking up his first foul. And Lewis is going to check out. In comes Tully. Robinson lobbing it in for Kale. Just beating the count. Kale on the attack. Spins into the lane. Left-handed floater, left short. Rebound tipped loose and goes out of bounds. And it's going to stay with Union City. 4:12 to go in the second quarter. And Coach Cisco going to take another timeout on the floor. So we'll take a moment And want to remind you that, as always, that you can visit TornadoTouch.net for all things Union City Schools, from the happenings at UC Elementary to what's going on at Union City Middle School and the latest at UCHS. You can stay in touch by checking out the website. Again, that is TornadoTouch.net. You can also follow on social media platforms, Facebook at Union City Schools, the home of the Golden Tornadoes, and on Twitter at UC Golden Tornadoes. Again, thanks to our fine sponsors who have brought to you this coverage tonight here at Haywood High School, Tyson Foods in Obion County, Herman Jenkins Motors, Jerry Ward Autoplex, Nutrient Ag Solutions, Commercial Bank and Trust, Titan Tire, Reynolds Brothers Tire Company in Union City and in Martin, American Roofing Soft Wash, the Union City Board of Education, Jerry Ward Autoplex, Five Seasons Men's Shop in Union City and in Martin, Alan Searcy Builders, the Citizens Bank, Kaiser Pharmacy, Shoe Shack in Union City and Martin, Northwest Tennessee Head Start, Early Head Start, McLean Power Systems, Obion County Nursing Home, Trailer Empire, Union City Forklift, Johnson Heating and Air, and Kirk Nissan. Back to action with DJ Robinson to inbound for Union City. Gives it inside. Lewis on the attack, and Lewis will score it off the screen. Jalen Lewis with 6 points and will cut the lead to 18, 28-10. 4:04 to go in the first half. Chapman picks up his dribble, swings it back out to Comage. A kick out, right wing, top of the key, Person. Back to Chapman. He's going to fire a right wing three. That one won't go. Put back up and in by Caden Pirtle. Robinson speeding into the front court. On the attack, floater with the right hand wouldn't go, couldn't get his own rebound. Person with the rebound, off and running, lost his dribble, stolen by Lattice. Lattice back to Davis, 30-10, Union City down by 20, 3:30 to go in the second quarter. Robinson on the attack in the lane, kicks out to Lewis. Lewis crossing over. Lewis into the lane to the rim. Lays it up. Wouldn't go. Rebound ripped down by Chapman. Outlet quickly to Snipe. Snipe to the rim. Lays it up. Lays it in. Count it. And a foul. And Davis whistled for his third. And Snipe will try to convert the old-fashioned three-point play. And Lattice checked out of the game as Kale will check back in. That one will drop for Snipe. Jabayan Snipe now with 3 points. 33-10. Robinson driving into the lane and a nice finish through contact. Robinson and Lewis combining for all of Union City's 12 here in the first half. Six apiece between the two of them, and Chapman is whistled for a turnover as he stepped on the line. Lattice will check in. Out comes C.J. Davis. As Haywood backs out of the pressure. 33-12, Haywood by 21, 2:48 to go in the first half. Robinson will pull up from the top of the key. Left it short. Rebound tipped high into the air. Tully fighting for it. Chapman comes away with it. Chapman into the front court. Free throw line. Jumper will not go, and a foul on the jump shot. And Chapman headed to the line. Jack Tully whistled for his first foul. As Chapman will knock down the first. He's got 3 points now on the evening. Two for two for Chapman. And now 4 points for him on the evening. 35-12 as Haywood continues to extend this lead. 2.5 to go here in the first half on WWGY Fulton, Froggy 99.3 in Union City. Robinson crossing over on the left wing. Around a screen, a near steal, runs into a trap, swings to Lattice, pump fakes. Lattice now will attack, gives out to Robinson. Again, just two scores for Union City tonight, Robinson and Lewis. As Robinson attacks, his shot is blocked, and a whistle and a foul. And two shots coming for D.J. Robinson, what will be the first free throw attempts of the night for Union City. did not get a chance to hear who that foul was on. Robinson will drop in the first of his two freebies here. As Robinson will go 2 for 2. 8 points for DJ Robinson. As Tully and Lattice make way for Monroe and Frankham. And Robinson cuts it to a 35-14 margin. 2 minutes to play in the second quarter. A three from the left wing for Chapman. Won't go. Offensive rebound ripped down by Jabian Snipe. Chapman, the putback from the short baseline, won't go. Rebound Lewis. Robinson working on Chapman, trying to get into the front court. On the right wing to Frankham. Frankham dishes in the corner. Monroe. Minute and a half to play in the first half. Robinson, free throw line. Gives in the corner, Frankham, who will drive, try to get it to Lewis, pass knocked out of bounds off of Frankham, and a turnover back to Haywood. Quintavious Comage will check in for Haywood, for Tylan Chapman. Person brings it into the front court for Haywood. A three from the right wing for Comage. Won't fall. Rebound Monroe. Monroe flings it ahead to Kale on the left wing. Hale picks up his dribble, gives it off to Lewis. A minute to play in the first half. Lewis into the lane through contact, off the glass and in. Jalen Lewis, he's got 8 first half points. 35-16, cuts it to 19. 50 seconds to go in the first half. A pump fake and Snipe, or Comage, will drive. Rebound by Lewis. 35-16, chance for Union City to cut it down to 16 before halftime. Monroe on the attack, into the lane, gives to a wide-open Lewis who finishes off the window. Jalen Lewis with 10 in the first half, and it's 35-18 with 22 seconds to go in the second quarter. Person gives on the left wing. A three from Jabian Snipe will drop. And the lead back up to 20. 38-18 with 2 seconds. Monroe floater at the horn will not go, and that will bring us to halftime. We'll take a break. When we come back, we'll have Coach Antoine Kobe for the Jerry Watt Autoplex girls postgame coaches interview, as well as the halftime stats presented by American Roofing Stopwatch. Stay tuned. Halftime coverage coming up right after this on the home of Union City Sports, Froggy 99.3.
This is Lynn Jenkins from Herman Jenkins Motors in Union City, Tennessee. On behalf of our entire staff, we want to say thank you for your continued support of our business. This Christmas season, may you and your family be blessed and enjoy the gift of one another. If you are looking for that special gift on wheels, stop by and see us at Herman Jenkins Motors, and we'll get you in a Chevrolet or GMC that fits your needs. Also, don't forget to check us out online at HermanJenkinsUnionCity.com. Merry Christmas and Happy New Year's from all of us here at Herman Jenkins Motors.
Remember Shoe Shack in Union City for neighbor and shoes and boots, both ladies and men's clothing, and the trendiest accessories, hats, purses, bags, and lots more. Come shop Shoe Shack for exciting arrivals for the season. Shoe Shack can clothe your entire family from head to toe. Be sure and follow Shoe Shack in Union City on Facebook for their very latest arrivals. For every season, please shop local and shop Shoe Shack in Union City, 2800 East Ruleford Avenue in Union City.
Game, Union City trailing Haywood by 20 as we head into the locker room. But now we're joined for the Jerrywood Autoplex girls postgame coaches interview by Union City girls head basketball coach Antoine Kobe. Coach, congrats, big win earlier tonight. What did you think about your team's performance?
With the exception of a spurt there late in the first half, in the second quarter, I think my girls played it pretty well. We played well as I've seen us play all year. Again, we were switching defense every other time down the floor. And that's something we've really been practicing trying to do, because I think we got to try to mix it up when we get into our district play. Those teams are too good not to give them a certain look the whole game. And so that's something we've been working on. We did a fine job of it tonight.
Obviously, you talk about that spurt where Haywood able to come back and make it a one-point game going into the locker room. What did they do, or what did your team not do that kind of allowed them to creep back into things?
Again, there was some ball pressure there that we just didn't handle well there in the second quarter. They kind of manned up on us, made a few plays, and we let one mistake become two and two become three, and they kind of got to rolling. They got confident. I told my ball club, I said, hey, we were up significantly on them, 7-8 points, and now you're going to have to play again to separate from them again. And after halftime, we responded.
So what was your message to them at halftime? Obviously, you talk about that. Your team blows up a 20-point cushion there in the second half. What did you do to kind of blow things open and run away with this one?
Well, just that. My junior point guard, Mara Theobald, just decided she was going to handle pressure by herself. She would get the ball and she handled it, whether they brought one body to her or two bodies to her, and she was able to get in the lane so many times and create easy opportunities for herself or for our teammates. And then they started guarding Amari one-on-one with no extra bodies on her, and I just tried to get her in space and let her kind of do her thing, and it worked out for us.
Obviously, you talk about the ball pressure that your team had struggled with the night before. Did you think tonight a little bit better?
Just a bit. Again, the second quarter was what I kind of seen the previous night. So that lets me know there's still work to be done there. The fact that we responded to come out in the third quarter lets me know that they're hearing me and that we're getting it a little bit and understanding what we got to do when that pressure comes.
Trinity Christian, second time around on Tuesday, final game before Christmas. How do you want to build on this performance going into that game?
Well, it'll be a different ball game. They will execute on offense differently than Haywood does. Haywood plays an up-tempo style. These girls are going to be more deliberate. We're going to have to guard offense. We're going to have to guard shooters. They're going to have to guard around the basket. Haywood didn't really throw the ball around the basket. So it's going to be a different ball game, and we know that. This is a tough team. I also think they weren't healthy or they had some girls out, a girl or two out. So they'll be stronger this time. Again, we got to be ready and prepared to play a good ball club.
Coach, as always, thanks so much for the time and good luck on Tuesday.
Thank you.
Coach Antoine Kobe joining us for the Jerry Wood Autoplex Girls post-game coaches interview. We'll take a break. We'll come back with the halftime stats presented by American Roofing Soft Wash. Stay tuned. More coming up right after this on the home of Union City Sports, Froggy 99.3.
Every season count. Start with Nutrien Ag Solutions. Every season starts by choosing the right seed for your unique growing conditions. Nutrien Ag Solutions carries a wide selection of top-performing seed brands, including Dyna-Grow seed, to get the most out of your acres. You also have the advantage of working with local seed experts, crop consultants, and agronomists ready to provide a custom recommendation to help you make the right decision every time. In Union City, visit Nutrien Ag Solutions at 530 North 5th Street. That's Nutrien Ag Solutions in Union City.
In today's economy, small businesses and consumers need every advantage to survive and get ahead. That's where community banks come in. Hi, I'm Tim Shanks at Commercial Bank and Trust Company. We give you the chance to succeed by providing the tools to start a small business, buy a home, fund a retirement, and fuel your dreams. Stop by and see us and let us show you why community banks build better communities. When banking matters, it matters who you bank with. Commercial Bank and Trust Company, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
At Reynolds Brothers Tire Company in Union City and Martin, they carry Cooper, Michelin, and Goodyear tires. In fact, they carry all major brands and many private brands, too. They even go the extra mile for their customers with a service package that includes road hazard, fix-free flats, and lifetime balancing. Reynolds Brothers, nobody beats their customer service. Reynolds Brothers Tire Company, 400 East Church Street in Union City and 505 North Lindell Street in Martin.
You already know American Roofing Soft Wash is your roof cleaning expert. But did you know that American Roofing Soft Wash also does roof repairs and much more? When your roof has damage, or if you just simply need a new roof, give American Roofing Soft Wash a call. KB and the guys would be happy to take care of you and all your roofing needs. Whether your project is residential or commercial, the experts from American Roofing Soft Wash are here to help. In need of a roof? Give KB a call at 731-636-9700. American Roofing Soft Wash, making roofs look great again.
Back at Haywood High School, time for the halftime stats presented by American Roofing Soft Wash. Taking a look on one side for Union City very quickly here. Jalen Lewis leading Union City with 10 points. DJ Robinson has the other eight, just those two in the scoring column for Union City in the first half. On the other side for Haywood, much more balanced and a big reason they're up 38-18. 4 for Tylan Chapman, 4 for Jamari Person, 6 for Janaris Snipe, 6 for LaKendrick Phillips, 6 for Jabian Snipe, 2 for Devarian Price, 2 for Caden Pirtle, and 7 for Jakari Kalmich. So obviously you've got 7 different Haywood players who have scored tonight for the Tomcats, and that is a big reason they are up. It was 15-6 at the end of one and 38-18 at the end of two quarters, and the final or the third quarter coming up on the other side of the break. We will take another quick break. When we come back, we'll have the tip off of the second, or the, well, the start of the second half as Union City tries to mount a comeback trailing by 20 here at halftime. Back in 2 minutes on the home of Union City Sports, Froggy 99.3.
High Seasons Men's Shop, they carry key brand names. Southern Marsh, Vineyard Vines, Fish Hippie, Michael Kors, and lots more. From suits to sportswear, from shoes to tuxedos, Five Seasons is the store where you'll find it all for the man who wants more. Remember, Five Seasons has big and tall sizes up to 4X and youth sizes as well. Be sure and follow Five Seasons Men's Shop on Facebook for daily specials. Five Seasons Men's Shop in Union City and Martin. Walk in a man, walk out the man.
Well, howdy. Pull up a saddle and sit a spell.
Hey, what's that?
Oh, that there on the campfire? Well, that there's the best tasting slab of beef this side of the Rockies. A ribeye from the meat shop. A bone-in ribeye from the meat shop means extra flavor, custom cut every time, and if it were any fresher, it'd still be mooing. Hitch up the horses, head on over to the meat shop, 1106 South 1st Street in Union City.
A good foundation. At Allen Searcy Builder Contractors, they know that it's the essential part of having a successful project, but it's also an important element in each relationship with their clients. Understanding and protecting the interests of each business they serve is why Allen Searcy continues to be the source for major commercial projects in our area for over 40 years. Allen Searcy Builder Contractors can help you with your project from concept and design all the way to construction. Call 885-7633 or go to allencearcy.com.
For your next car or truck, come see Jerry Ward Autoplex in Union City. Jerry Ward and his all-star team have a lot filled with pre-owned small, mid-sized, and full-sized cars, SUVs, and nice trucks, too. And if they don't have the right size, they'll find it for you. No matter what you're looking for, score your next ride at Jerry Ward Autoplex, Realfoot Avenue in Union City, or online at jerrywardautoplex.com. Like Jerry always says, don't dream it, drive it. Be a winner with Jerry Ward Autoplex in Union City.
Start of the second half here at Haywood High School. Union City has still not come out of the locker room. Haywood is out on the floor. They're ready. Coach Sisko was very unhappy, shall we say, on the bench in the first half with his team. We will see when Union City comes out of the locker room for Haywood. They'll start the second half. It is Janaris Snipe, Jakari Komich, Tylan Chapman as Union City making their way out. Jamari Person as well as Jabian Snipe. And so Union City going to hustle their bench to the other side of the floor. Trailing 38-18 as we start the second half. Louisville inbound as Union City now going right to left on your radio dial. Haywood will go left to right. Robinson brings it into the front court. On the attack, into the lane, trying to dump it down low to Davis. Swatted away by Janaris Snipe. Rebound off and running is Person. To the cup, and Person can't finish. Put back up and in by Janaris Snipe. Kale quickly on the other end for Union City. Crossing over. Kicks it back out to Robinson. Robinson on the right wing. Flings for Kale. Extra pass. Lattis in the corner. Will fire for three. Left it short. Rebound ripped down by Person. Off and running is Jabian Snipe to the rim and a foul as Snipe was attacking. He'll get free throws coming up. It's DJ Robinson whistled for the foul. Will be his first. As Snipe will drop that one in. Defense! And we'll rattle home the pair. 3 for 3 at the line for Jabayan Snipe. 8 points for him. And a turnover by Union City. Or the ball actually, I guess, just rolled away. 8 points for Snipe. Or it is a turnover against Union City. On the inbound, as Chapman will fling it in, top of the key to Janaris Snipe. Person on the attack, dishes out Comage. Extra pass, Jabayan Snipe for three. In and out wouldn't go. Lattice the rebound. 42-18. Haywood on top with 7:08 to go in the third quarter. Up the floor, Lewis spinning into the lane. Lewis with the left hand, blocked by Janaris Snipe. Rebound, Lattice. Lattice on the attack, can't finish, and a foul called. And Lattice heading to the free throw line with 6:59 to go in the third. So Lattice with an opportunity to get on the score sheet for the first time tonight, and drops in the first. And Lattice will go 2 for 2. He is the third Golden 20 to score after DJ Robinson and Joseph or Jalen Lewis have combined for all of the 18 previous points for Union City. Now 42-20, Haywood by 22. Top of the key, Person on the attack, dishes down low and trying to dunk it, but instead going for the lay-in is Javneris Snipe. And he's got 10 tonight. And a steal by Snipe. Up the floor on the left wing, Jabayan Snipe, an open three, wouldn't go. Rebound to Janaris Snipe. Tapped out to Comage. On the left wing, Jabayan Snipe now cutting into the lane. Lost his dribble, stolen by Davis. Davis on the attack, in transition, to the basket, knocked away, and a foul. Going to go on Jakari Comage. And so C.J. Davis heading to the line for two shots. Davis cannot connect off the back iron. The second for Davis will drop in. 1 of 2 on the trip. And quickly comes Haywood on the response. On the right wing, Comage with a pump, pulls up, short baseline, two, will drop in. Comage now has 9. Lattice a 3, to answer is nothing but nylon. Lattice now with 5 in the second half, and Coach Sisko will take a Commercial Bank timeout. 5:59 to go in the third, back in 30 seconds on the home of Union City Sports.
The Citizen Bank online banking allows their customers secure and convenient access to their accounts using the internet anytime. With some of their online banking functions, you can access and print information on all of your accounts, including loans, confirm your deposits, withdrawals, and checks cleared, view deposits and checks cleared, and receive email alerts. Now that's taking care of business for you. The Citizens Bank, Hickman, Fulton, and Union City. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
46-24 as we resume action. 5:59 to go in the third quarter here at Haywood High School. As Chapman will bring it in for Haywood. Dishes right wing, Comage on the block for Jabayan Snipe. Chapman spinning into the lane, dishes out. Comage lost it, and it turns over to Haywood. 46-24, 5:44 to go in the third quarter. As Davis is going to check out, in comes Tully for Union City. Davis running to the bathroom, it looks like. At least you just hope that's all it is. Robinson sprinting up the floor, gives it to Kale. Kale trying to get through traffic, steps on the line, and a turnover back to Haywood. Person, top of the key, working on Lewis. Gives on the left wing for Comage. Pass tipped and a steal by Lewis. Lewis on a breakaway to the basket, and Lewis will hammer it home with one hand. Jalen Lewis with the hops, jams it home. And we'll cut it to 20. Chapman, pass to Janaris Snipe. Back top of the key to Person. Gives inside, a steal by Lattice. Robinson now weaving in transition. Kicks in the corner. Kale will fire a three. Kale will drop in a trifecta. First points of the night for Ben Kale, and Union City has cut it to 17 with 4:48 to go in the third quarter. Chapman, right wing, Person, corner three from Comage to answer. Yes. 3 points. Comage with 12 now, and the lead back up to 20. 4.5 to go in the third. Kale up ahead to Tully. Back out to Robinson. Robinson banging his way into the lane. Gives out to Lattice. He'll try a three. Lattice connects again from downtown. 8 for him. Now all of them here in the third quarter. Union City trims it back to 17. Chapman coming quickly. Pulls up from 18 feet. Can't get it to go. Rebound Tully. Chance to cut into it more here for Union City. 49-32, 4 minutes to play, third quarter. Lewis has it stolen away by Person. Person to the rim, laying it up and laying it in. 51-32, Lattice will try again. Wide on it, cans another three. Lattice in double figures now with 11. 51-35, 3.5 to go in the third. Person, top of the key. Gives on the left wing for Jabayan Snipe. Back to Comage, off the screen. Chapman into the lane. Will drop and account the foul off on the free throw line jumper. That is Ben Kale who gets tagged with the foul. And Chapman cannot convert the old-fashioned three-point play. Knocked out of bounds off of Lewis. And it will be Haywood basketball. 53-35. 3:19 to go here in the third quarter. Chapman will inbound. Tosses into Person. In the corner, Chapman drives, dishes out. Jabayan Snipe, extra pass to Comage in the corner. Back out to Snipe. Top of the key for Person. Bobbing it on the block. Janaris Snipe back in Tully down. A pump fake. Tully with a block. And Robinson tried to save it. They'll say it went out of bounds before he did. It'll stay with Haywood with 3:01 to go in the third. Snipe. Or that is Chapman, who gives it to a streaking Person who lays it up and in off the inbound. Lead back up to 20, 55-35. Kale trying to avoid a trap. Gives it into Robinson. Robinson into the lane, off the window with a nice left-handed finish. Three Union City players in double figures now. Robinson with 10, Lewis with 12, Lattice with 11. 55-37, Person dishes in the corner, Comage. Passes out. Jabayan Snipe, a left wing three. Wouldn't go. Tully the rebound. Robinson had it deflected. It will stay with Union City. Went off of Jakari Comage. 55-37. 2:26 to go in the third. Lattice tosses in for Robinson. Robinson up ahead. Lattice tosses ahead to Tully. Tully back out Robinson. Runs into traffic, stolen by Person. Chance to push it back to 20-plus for Haywood. Chapman into the corner. A three from Comage. Won't go. Rebound by Haywood. Blocked by Tully on the putback and a foul. Antrell Jones with the rebound for Haywood and a foul going to go on Tully. And so it will be the sophomore, Jones, headed to the line for two and drops it in. Jones will go one of two. Right, rebounded by Robinson. Robinson trying to get it into the front court and flinging it ahead to Lewis. Lewis just gets it across the timeline. Dishes out to Davis. Davis attacking. Short corner. Tully going to fire the long baseline two. Won't go. Rebound, Gennaro Snipe. 1:40 to play, third quarter. 56-37. Haywood still in front. Left wing, Person on the attack. Pass stolen by Lewis. Lewis flings it ahead to Tully. Takes a dribble. Tully bungles it as it's ripped away by Jones. Jones has it stolen away by Davis. Davis a pump, and Davis will finish with the right hand. 56-39. Union City trims it to 17. 1:12 to go in the third quarter. And a whistle and a commercial bank timeout for Haywood with 1:05 to go in the third quarter. So while we have a moment, let's go to the Reynolds Brothers Tire Company scoreboard as Union City trailing 56-39 here late in the third quarter. Lexington defeating Madison tonight 57-40. We mentioned earlier, Gibson County girls go on the road, pick up a big win over Henry County 74-33. Bradford girls picking up a 46-24 win over Halls this evening as well. As we return to action, 1:05 to go in the third quarter, Haywood 56, Union City 39. Haywood has led virtually the entire night. Person, left wing, Jones going to try for three. Jones can't get it to go. Davis with the rebound and off and running. Top of the key, gives to Kale. In transition, three ball will not go for Kale. Ripped away by Davis. Down low to Lewis, and Lewis off the glass and in. Lewis has 14 tonight, and the lead is 15. Person into the front court, driving into the lane. Blocked. Now they lay it up and in with Snipe. He couldn't get it to go. Rebound, Davis, and a foul on Gennaro Snipe. Will be his first. And Union City will take it out of bounds from the far end. 28 seconds to go. And the third, Robinson, top of the key. On the drive, gives off to Lattice. Lattice now into the lane, dishes out to Davis. 13 seconds to go in the quarter. Robinson with nine. Coach Sisko says clear it out. 5 seconds. Robinson into the lane. Pulls up at the free throw line and can't get it to go. Rebound Snipe, and that'll bring us to the end of three. Union City battles back, but they still trail by 15, 56-41 as we head into the fourth quarter. Back in 60 seconds on the home of Union City Sports.
Have you heard the news? Kaiser Pharmacy has a new gift shop, Miles and Bishop. You've always known us for our unique baby gifts, but we decided it's time to expand and offer gifts for all occasions. While you're here shopping for others, be sure to pick up a little happy for yourself. You deserve it. Come see Olivia Riley at Miles and Bishop, where the gift wrapping and service is free. Remember, it's now Miles and Bishop inside Kaiser Pharmacy in Union City.
Remember, Shoe Shack in Union City for neighbor and shoes and boots, both ladies and men's clothing and the trendiest accessories, hats, purses, bags, and lots more. Come shop Shoe Shack for exciting arrivals for the season. Shoe Shack can clothe your entire family from head to toe. Be sure and follow Shoe Shack in Union City on Facebook for their very latest arrivals. For every season, please shop local and shop Shoe Shack in Union City, 2800 East Ruleford Avenue in Union City.
Start of the fourth quarter, Union City has trimmed the lead to 15, but still have a lot of work to do if they're going to find a way to come back and win this one. Chapman on the left wing, 56-41, Union City trailing by 15. Person, top of the key for the Tomcats, who have led since the jump. A near steal, it is stolen by Lewis. Lewis on the breakaway, driving it to the cup, trying to dish it down low, stolen away by Jones. Jones up ahead, Comage to the cup, laying it in for Haywood. Comage now with 14 for Haywood. Robinson driving inside, floated with the right hand, wouldn't go, rebound Janaris Snipe. Chapman in transition, weaving his way, pulls up at the free throw line and knocks down a jumper. To 41 as Haywood pushes the lead back out to 19. Robinson with the free throw line to Lewis. Lewis will drive into the lane, count it, and a foul. Jalen Lewis going to get one more at the line. Lewis has struggled from the line this season, can cut the lead back to 16 with the free throw here. And left it short, rolls out of bounds, and it will go back to Haywood. Union City with some subs. D'Angelo Monroe and Finn Frankham check in, as does Jack Tully. Ben Kale, Jalen Lewis check out. 60-43, the new score. Haywood by 17. Person, top of the key. Chapman into the lane, dishes out. Jones on the left wing. And on the right wing is Jones, back out to Comage. Person swings, Chapman, left wing. Chapman to Comage. Haywood being patient here, trying to run some clock. They dump it inside. Chapman with a nice move, down low to a streaking Snipe, who lays it up and in. Good ball movement from Haywood. And they get the deuce. 62-43, 6:05 to play. Davis, top of the key. Up his dribble and a whistle and a traveling violation. He's going to turn it over back to Haywood. And a Commercial Bank timeout called by Haywood. Or now, not quite. Coach Cisco and some discussions with the official. I think Haywood wanted a tech and they didn't get it. Not sure what that was about, but we're back to action. Chapman will bring it up for the Tomcats. Working on Robinson. Swings it out to Comage. On the right wing, it's Jones. Jones will hand it back off to Chapman. Spinning into the lane. Nice move. Off the window. Wouldn't go. Rebound snatched down by Lewis. Robinson up ahead. Lattice. Runs into traffic, nearly stolen away. Robinson gets it back. Robinson somehow weaving his way through traffic, and this time it is stolen by Person. Numbers for Haywood. Up ahead, Chapman. Down low to Person. Person off the window and in. Haywood just putting on a nice display, sharing the basketball tonight. Scoring is spread out. Robinson into the lane, off the glass and in. Count it, and a foul. Janaris Snipe picks up his third. And Robinson headed to the free throw line. And cannot convert the old-fashioned three-point play. Rebound Comage. Snipe on the left wing. Picks up the dribble, dishes out to Jones. Jones, Person, now left wing, it's Chapman. Chapman spinning, and a whistle. He picked up the foot and a traveling violation on Haywood, and a turnover back to Union City. 4:52 to go in the fourth quarter. Haywood ahead by 19. D'Angelo Monroe into the game for DJ Robinson. Kale, top of the key, gives out Lattice. Going to fire a long-distance shot, and it couldn't go. Rebounded by Person. In transition quickly, Haywood on the break. Person with a nice move to the cup and lays it up and in. 14 tonight for Jamari, or for Jamari Person, or 12 for Jamari Person, rather. Lewis, top of the key. Lead back to 21. Handing it off for Monroe. Monroe going to heave one from deep. Won't go. Rebound still tipped loose, and Phillips comes down with it for Haywood. Phillips crossing over. Now dishes outside. Person to Chapman. He'll fire a three. Chapman can't get it to go. Lewis the rebound. Lewis on the right wing. Crosses overhead. His pocket picked. Phillips on a breakaway all alone and will play it up and in. 68-45, a 23-point lead for Haywood with 3.5 to play. Monroe back over to Kale. Kale on the attack. Had it stolen away. It rolls out of bounds, and it's going to stay with Union City. And Robinson will check back in as Lewis will make way. Frankham will check back in as well. Full-scale subs for Haywood as Caden Pirtle, Idarian Clark, Jamalachi Bond, and a couple of numbers that I don't have on my roster have checked into the game. Robinson floats in for Frankham. Frankham on the attack. Probes, lays it up, wouldn't go, but free throws coming for Ben Frankham. Pirtle tagged with his first foul. And Finn Frankham cannot get the first to go off the back iron. Robinson out. In comes D'Angelo Monroe. Frankham 0 for 2. Rebound corralled by Haywood. And a whistle and a foul on Frankham. Nolan Chandler going to check in. Out comes Joseph Lattice. 68-45, 3:09 to go in the fourth quarter. As Bond brings it into the front court. Top of the key with Clark. Handing it off here for Pirtle. On the attack, down low. Pass blocked from behind, but a putback won't go either. Rebound tipped loose and will go with Union City. Monroe into the front court, crossing over. Hands off to Frankham. Frankham will drive into the lane. Pass blocked, or shot blocked. Rebound by Haywood, off and running. And over the outstretched fingertips of Idarian Clark in a turnover. Back to Union City. Jamarius Abbott going to check in. Out comes Finn Frankham. .232 to go in the basketball game. 68-45, Haywood in firm control. Monroe picks up the dribble. Kishik kicks out to Kale. Top of the key. Chandler going to fire a three. Nolan Chandler rattles one home. And Chandler, after the bucket, will cut it to 20, and a timeout on the floor. Back in 60 seconds on the home of Union City Sports.
Looking for an early.
Out of the timeout, this one rolls out of bounds. Still 68-48. Haywood up by 20 as Cohen Simpson will check into the game. 1:49 to play. And it will be D'Angelo Monroe to bring it up the floor for Union City. It's Simpson, Monroe, Chandler, Abbott, and Tully on the floor for Union City with a minute to go. A minute 40 to go. Monroe trying to hand it off, flings it for Tully on the left wing. Tully, Simpson will step into a left wing three. Simpson will connect from downtown. And they say Haywood stepped on the line in a turnover back to Union City with 1:26 to play. Chandler will inbound. Gives in the corner. Abbott. Abbott, top of the key. Around a Chandler screen. Abbott into the lane. Floats into the corner. Deflected out of bounds with 1:10 to play, and it's Union City basketball on the baseline. Chandler will inbound, trying to get it into Tully. It is into Tully, and Tully finishes it. Cuts it to a 15-point margin with a minute to play. Top of the key with Clark. Down inside, Clark will get the bucket and the foul. Chandler gets tagged with the foul. And Adarian Clark at the free throw line. And whistles blow this thing dead. As Clark heads to the bench. Not sure what that was about. Quintavious Comage will shoot the free throw. This one will drop in. Comage knocks it down. Monroe hands off Abbott. Abbott on the attack. Pumps out to Chandler. Back to Monroe. Dishes over to Abbott. Pass tipped and deflected. On a steal. Breakaway for Pierce. To the basket. Pierce will lay it up and in. 33 seconds to go. Haywood back up by 20. 73-51. Abbott on the left wing. Now driving into the lane. Free throw line. Jumper will drop for Jamarius Abbott. 13 seconds to go. Haywood on the other end. Spinning. Shot is up and in for number 24, who I don't have on my roster. Monroe will finish on the other end for Union City as the horn expires. 75-55, the final score. Union City falls tonight here at the hands of Haywood and will fall to 3-8 on the season. And we'll be back in action next week as they take on Trinity Christian for the rematch of an earlier meeting this season between the two. We will take a break. When we come back, we'll start up the Five Seasons Men's Shop post-game show, and later we'll be joined by Coach Shane Sisko for the Jerry Wood Autoplex post-game coaches interview. Stay tuned. Coming up right after this on the home of Union City Sports, WWGY Fulton, Froggy 99.3 in Union City.
This is Larry Sherwood, administrator of your Obion County Nursing and Rehab. So now the unthinkable has happened. You were not prepared to hear these words, and you were hoping that you would never hear them. Your mom or dad needs the services of a nursing home. Now what? Call Obion County Nursing and Rehab. We are here to help. You have questions? We have the answers that will help guide you into making the right decisions. So come meet our family who cares for your family at Obion County Nursing and Rehab, 1084 East County Home Road, Union City, Tennessee.
For all your trailer needs, Trailer Empire in Union City is your go-to source. From small trailers to big trailers, Trailer Empire has the trailer perfectly matched to your load, job, and tow vehicle. With brands like Big Tex, Delta, Caliber, and more, they've got you covered at Trailer Empire. They also have enclosed dump truck and aluminum trailers. Don't worry about your credit because you're already approved. Put your hitch to good use. Call Trailer Empire today. 731-507-0555.
And online at trailer-empire.com.
This is Larry Sherwood, administrator of Ural Vine County Nursing and Rehab. So now the unthinkable has happened. You were not prepared to hear these words, and you were hoping that you would never hear them. Your mom or dad needs the services of a nursing home. Now what? Call Vine County Nursing and Rehab. We are here to help. You have questions? We have the answers that will help guide you into making the right decisions. So come meet our family who cares for your family at Vine County Nursing and Rehab, 1084 East County Home Road, Union City, Tennessee.
For all your trailer needs, Trailer Empire in Union City is your go-to source. From small trailers to big trailers, Trailer Empire has the trailer perfectly matched to your load, job, and tow vehicle. With brands like Big Tex, Delta, Caliber, and more, they've got you covered at Trailer Empire. They also have enclosed dump truck and aluminum trailers. Don't worry about your credit because you're already approved. Put your hitch to good use. Call Trailer Empire today. 731-507-0555.
And online at trailer-empire.com.
Union City falls tonight here at Haywood and will fall to 4-7 on the season, or 3-8 on the season, as we crank up the Five Seasons Men's Shop postgame show. We'll have the Jerry Wood Autoplex postgame coaches interview to come after Coach Cisco has a moment to address his team. Obviously a tough loss tonight for Union City, but they fought hard in the second half. They at least were able to get into the 50s in a better offensive effort tonight than we have seen in the last couple of games. Let's take a look at the final stats tonight, powered by American Roofing Soft Wash. Jalen Lewis leading all scorers tonight with 16 points. DJ Robinson pitches in 12. Joseph Lattis with 11, and several other contributions tonight. C.J. Davis, Nolan Chandler, Ben Kale, and Cohen Simpson drop in 3. D'Angelo Monroe and Jamarius Abbott drop in 2. For Union City. On the other end for Haywood, much more spread out. Tylan Chapman with 8 points. Jamari Person with 12. Janaris Snipe with 12. LeKendrick Phillips chips in 8. Jabian Snipe with 8. 4 from DeVarian Price. 2 for Caden Pirtle. 2 for Edarian Clark. 14 for Jakari Comage. And 1 from Ontrell Jones. And 1 for Quintavious Comage. Looking at the final box score tonight, Haywood led 15-6 at the end of one and outscored Union City 23-12 in the second quarter to lead by 20, 38-18 at halftime. Union City cut it to 15 heading into the final frame at 56-41, outscoring Haywood 23-18 in the third. But Haywood outscores Union City 19-16 down the final stretch to win by a 75-57 scoreline. So Union City falling tonight here at the hands of Haywood, again falling to 4-8 on the season. Haywood will improve to 8-2. Union City will wrap up the pre-Christmas slate with a matchup against Trinity Christian on Tuesday night. Haywood will host Bolivar after an extended period off. That game not until January 3rd, unless some other games are scheduled that were not available online. So Union City, plenty to clean up, and obviously if you're Coach Cisco, I think you have to be happy about the second half effort and gave yourself a chance to get back into the game and make it much more competitive, because you look at the final box in the second half, a much more competitive game, 23-18. Union City wins by 5 in the third quarter and 19-16 in the fourth. Union City losing by a 3-point margin. So obviously the second half much more competitive, but that third quarter really proved to be Union City's undoing here tonight. We'll take a break. When we come back, we'll hopefully have Coach Cisco for the Jerry Wood Autoplex postgame coaches interview. More coming up on the Five Seasons Bench Shop postgame show after this on the home of Union City Sports, Froggy 99.3.
Every season count. Start with Nutrient Ag Solutions. Every season start.
See Shoe Shack in Union City and in Martin. Northwest Tennessee Head Start, Early Head Start, McLean Power Systems, Obion County Nursing Home, Trailer Empire, Union City Forklift, Johnson Heating and Air, and Kirk Nissan. Again, just awaiting Coach Shane Cisco to join us for the Jerry Ward Autoplex postgame coaches interview as we wind things down as Union City falls 75-57 tonight here on the road at Haywood on WWGY Fulton, Froggy 99.3 in Union City. I want to remind you, as always, that you can visit TornadoTouch.net for all things Union City schools, from the happenings at UC Elementary to what's going on at Union City Middle School and the latest at UCHS. Stay in touch by checking out the website. Again, that is TornadoTouch.net. Mike Cutchins and his team does a great job over with all of the press releases at TornadoTouch.net. You can also follow on social media platforms, Facebook at Union City Schools, the home of the Golden Tornadoes, and on Twitter at UC Golden Tornadoes. Let's go back to the Reynolds Brothers Tire Company in Union City and in Martin scoreboard as we await Coach Shane Sisko for the Jerry Ward Autoplex post-game coaches interview. Again, final score here tonight is 75-57, Union City falling to Haywood on the road. Jackson Christian picking up a win over Big Sandy, 72-23 in girls action, and then in boys, another big win, 67-21, a final score in that one. Lexington with a win tonight, 57-40 over Madison. Gibson County girls picking up a win, 74-33 on the road at Henry County. Bradford girls picking up a 46-24 win over Halls earlier today. And then last night, it was Fayette Ware picking up a win, 60-48 over Bolivar. Dyersburg picking up a win over Gibson County, 58-48. Liberty over JCM, 66-25. Continuing to see other scores. Fayette Academy picks up a 41-38 win over MHEA. McNary Central Boys over Adamsville, 76-53. McKenzie pulls away from Huntingdon last night, 71-53. Crockett County with a big win over Humboldt, 76-46, ends up being the final in that one. Henry County Boys last night picking up a win over Dyer County, 81-74. Chester County last night, 83-81 winners and a narrow two-point win over Scotts Hill. Trinity Christian picking up the win last night in boys, 76-48. Milan over Dresden, 53-31. And again last night, Haywood, 85-51 winners over Jackson Southside. Again, the upcoming schedule, we'll take a look at that for Union City as we again are just awaiting Coach Shane Sisko for the Jerry Ward Autoplex post-game coaches interview. Obviously, Union City falling tonight to Haywood as Coach Sisko now out of the locker room making his way over. We'll have him here in just a moment. But looking ahead, Haywood tonight, obviously, Trinity Christian on Tuesday, and then they open with Dyersburg at the LA Realty Holiday Tournament at Milan on Wednesday, December 28th. That game tips off at 1:15, and then two more games to be determined in that tournament. After Christmas, it's Fayette Ware, Huntingdon. Fayette Ware to end the preseason slate, and then district play will open with road trips to Huntingdon and Milan, and then a home date against Martin Westview. As Coach Shane Sisko on his way over to join us for the Jerry Ward Autoplex postgame coaches interview is Union City falling tonight 75-57. On the road here at Haywood on WWGY Fulton, Froggy 99.3 in Union City. As we'll get Coach Sisko on here in just a moment. And we're now joined for the Jerry Ward Autoplex postgame coaches interview by Coach Shane Sisko. Coach, a tough loss here tonight. What were your overall thoughts on the game for your team?
I thought we got much better in the second half. Challenged our kid at halftime. Thought there were too many plays, John, in the first half that we quit on. Thought that we would turn the basketball over because we were, a little bit intimidated by the situation. We just didn't respond to the physicality of it and the athleticism the other team, obviously Haywood brings. I just told him at halftime, I said, we've got to go out and accept it. I said, this can go one of two ways. This can get really, really, really ugly, or we can go out and compete. And he's proud of our kids, how they competed the second half. And we got better tonight, second half. I'm not up for more victories at any point, but I feel like our kids got better. I feel like we responded to the challenge. You know, that's a I guess we got to 13 one time maybe there in the second half, we got to. And I think when he subbed finally, it was a 15 or 16-point game. So, you know, again, not in for more victories, but, you know, we won the second half, and they continued to press, especially early in the third. And our ability to break the press led to some baskets, and they got out of it. And we tell our kids all the time, if you can handle pressure early and show some success, again, a lot of people get out of it. And, you know, in the first half, we didn't. They're the ones that had success, and it was like, you know, throwing blood in the water for a bunch of sharks. You know, they were everywhere. But just thought second half we responded, John, much better. That's a really good basketball team we just played. And just proud of our kids how they played in the second half. Don't like the outcome, but much better effort there in the second half.
So going back to the first half, obviously you talked about it. They really took it to you, up 20 at halftime. What was kind of your message? You talked about that a little bit. And then what were kind of the major adjustments that you made to get things going better in the second half?
Well, first off, there was 5 turnovers to start the second quarter. That's the ball game. There's a 20-point deficit at halftime because of 5 turnovers to start the second quarter. And, again, it was just not willing. You know, we tell our kids all the time, you've got to be willing to accept 2 defenders. 2 defenders run at you, you've got to be willing to accept 2. You got to back dribble. You got to be able to pick it up, be strong, step through the trap. And first half, it was when we saw a body, we just picked it up and threw it away. And I thought we were much better at that in the second half. Again, we accepted 2. We got the people in the right spots on the floor. You know, just several things that I thought we did a much better job of there. We rebound the ball much better tonight against a more physical, a much bigger team than what we have at times this year against smaller teams. So, you know, just overall, like I say, just there were some positives we can take from it. You know, again, never want to lose ever. But, you know, you have to in this situation here, I think we can take some positives from this game.
You talk about obviously a lot of the positives that happened there in the second half, Coach. Trinity Christian coming up on Tuesday. You've seen them once. So how do you take the positives in winning the second half like you talked about in a much more competitive second half? How do you take that, build on that, and perhaps turn it into some wins against Trinity Christian and Dyersburg coming up?
Well, first off, let me talk about the play right now of Jalen Lewis. Tonight.
Yeah.
You know, been around Jalen for 4 years, and that's probably the best effort we've had out of him 4 years. And as Coach Kobe told him in the dressing room, he can't go back to that other stuff that we've seen at times. This has got to be the Jalen Lewis that we see. And we've seen it in him at times. We've seen spurts of him do that at times. But it's not ever been anything on a consistent basis. And, man, he got in there and he was as physical as our guys were tonight. You know, I think that one play in transition was very indicative of that, the play that he made. You know, just you know, he played tonight like we need him to play, and played tonight the way, if he plays that way, it makes us a lot better when we roll in the district play in January. Still think that there's good play out of Jack Tiller tonight. I thought he had a couple of block shots around the basket. You know, much better play out of him. Joseph Lattis shot it better tonight in the second half. You know, we've just got to get we've got to get everybody on the same page doing the things that we need to do correctly. You know, again, that old saying, the old thing we've been saying all year, our margin of error is so small. And when we turn it over like we did in the first half, that really, really hampers us, obviously. You know, especially now in the situation where we're, you know, behind the eight ball being without Malachi. Looking ahead, you know, it'll be a tall task on Tuesday night. In my opinion, probably the worst performance that we've had all year long was when we went to TCA almost a month ago now. I thought we were very lethargic. Didn't think that we were. We brought any enthusiasm or excitement at all. Just very lackadaisical play overall by our play down there. Very disappointed that night when we left. You know, the effort you saw in the second half tonight is the effort that we've got to see if we're going to, you know, if we're going to have a chance on Tuesday night. You know, they shot the ball extremely well at their place against us when we played down there. We'll have to make sure that we're. You know, getting out and defending 3-point shooters. Dyersburg, the first game after Christmas break, extremely big physical team. We scrimmaged them preseason. You know, they've got a lot of size. They've got some kids that are real physical. It'll be a formidable challenge on the first game after Christmas for sure.
Coach, as always, thanks so much for the time and good luck going forward.
One more thing.
Go ahead.
My mom and dad's 56th wedding anniversary today.
Oh, well,
so,
congratulations.
Like to wish them a 56th wedding anniversary today. Two of the greatest people in the world, and you know, love them to death and wouldn't be where I'm at today or able to do the things I'm out to, able to do today without those two. And certainly appreciate those two and love them. And, you know, he rewarded her with a trip to Haywood. So I don't know what that means. But that's probably what he's done for the majority of 56 years, if the truth is known. So, again, appreciative of those
yes.
two and everything. And appreciate you, John. We'll see you on Tuesday night.
Yes, sir. Appreciate it, Coach. As always, for the time, good luck going forward. And again, happy anniversary to the Ciscos there. We'll take another quick break. We'll wrap things up right after this on the home of Union City Sports, Froggy 99.3.
At Reynolds Brothers Tire Company in Union City and Martin, they carry Cooper, Michelin, and Goodyear tires. In fact, they carry all major brands and many private brands, too. They even go the extra mile for their customers with a service package that includes road hazard, fix-free flats, and lifetime balancing. Reynolds Brothers, nobody beats their customer service. Reynolds Brothers Tire Company, 400 East Church Street in Union City and 505 North Lindell Street in Martin.
At Five Seasons Men's Shop, they carry key brand names. Southern Marsh, Vineyard Vines, Fish Hippie, Michael Kors, and lots more. From suits to sportswear, from shoes to tuxedos, Five Seasons is the store where you'll find it all for the man who wants more. Remember, Five Seasons has big and tall sizes up to 4X and youth sizes as well. Be sure and follow Five Seasons Men's Shop on Facebook for daily specials. Five Seasons Men's Shop in Union City and Martin. Walk in a man, walk out the man.
For your next car or truck, come see Jerry Ward Autoplex in Union City. Jerry Ward and his all-star team have a lot filled with pre-owned small, mid-sized, and full-sized cars, SUVs, and nice trucks, too. And if they don't have the right size, they'll find it for you. No matter what you're looking for, score your next ride at Jerry Ward Autoplex, Real Foot Avenue in Union City, or online at jerrywardautoplex.com. Like Jerry always says, don't dream it, drive it. Be a winner with Jerry Ward Autoplex in Union City.
American Roofing Soft Wash is your roof cleaning expert. For all kinds of pressure washing, contact KB at American Roofing Soft Wash. They also do patios, driveways, gutters, sidewalks, vinyl siding, semi-trucks, trailers, and heavy equipment. American Roofing Soft Wash specializes in dirty roofs, and by cleaning your roof, it'll preserve the shingles, adding 2 to 5 years of life. Check them out on Facebook at American Roofing Soft Wash or call KB at 731-636-9700. American Roofing Soft Wash, making roofs look great again.
Again, the final score tonight is Union City falls at the hands of Haywood and will fall to 3-8 on the season. Again, back in action on Tuesday, final game before the Christmas holiday. They'll take on Trinity Christian. We're on the air at 5:45 back at Marty Cisco Gymnasium. That's going to do it for our coverage tonight online on Froggy 99.3 and radio NWTN.com. For myself, John Thornton, for Jared Mims, for Sean Kiesler, thank all of you for tuning in on radio NWTN.com or Froggy 99.3 FM. Good night and God bless from Haywood High School in Brownsville, Tennessee.